Ladies and gentlemen, it is here. We are here tonight. XWF Legacy kicking up with our pre-show match. And Jacob Drake is making his way down to the ring. This is going to be a triple threat match to crown the new number one contender for the XWF Internet Championship. Thank you so much for joining us. If you're live, drop us some comments in the live chat. If you're watching on playback, that's cool too. Be sure to give us a like, subscribe, ring the bell, drop us a comment. You know the deal by now, ladies and gentlemen. But for now, let's focus on this match. And this first guy here is Jacob Drake. And you could say that Jacob Drake is one of the greatest, if not the greatest, XWF Internet Champion of all time, with two very, very good title runs. And he has his work cut out for him tonight, ladies and gentlemen, because this is a triple threat match. And he's got two very, very competitive and competent opponents. The first of which is Junction. The second of which is Hazard. But Jacob Drake looks ready for action, man. He looks ready to win that number one contendership. Jacket off, bandana off, and here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, the fans erupt because they want to see this guy right here leave tonight as the number one contender for the XWF Internet Championship. This man is Junction. Big fan of Junction, man. Wait a minute. Hazard doing a jump start, as always, man, at every CPV. No way. He got him. He got him. Boom, thunder bomb. Junction saw it coming. He scouted it. He knew. He's seen that Hazard is a little weasel that likes to jump start people. In fact, Hazard jump started Junction at the XWF No Turning Back CPV, and Hazard is laid out, man. So Junction saw it coming. He knows what this weasel is like. Junction is a clever guy. You don't hit him twice, man. You do not hit him twice. Junction getting in the ring, looking ready, goggles off, taking off the jumper. Jacob Drake looking ready for action, man. We're going to start this match as a singles match because Hazard is Blue Thunder bombed on the outside and still trying to recover. So let's start this match off with Junction versus Jacob Drake. Remember, number one contendership, Jacob Drake runs in, but Junction flapjacks him. Junction looking ready, and more ready than I've seen him in a long time. Nice strikes into the corner there from Junction. And he's grabbing the wrist of Jacob Drake, and Irish whips him in. Nice forearm smash. Jacob Drake crumbles down. Junction runs in with a knee. You can tell that Junction wants this number one contendership, because if he could win this match, win the championship, and get 10 defenses on it, he could cash in on his brother or Lord Lore, depending on who wins the XWF Heavyweight Championship later tonight. Jacob Drake, trying to take control of this match, goes for the Irish whip, but Junction reverses it and throws him over the top rope. Junction going for a suplex from the apron. The strength is needed, but wait a minute. Jacob Drake reverses it and drops Junction down from that suplex onto the floor and kicks him in between the shoulder blades. That is vicious, ladies and gentlemen. That is vicious. Jacob Drake picking Junction up. Junction kicks him in the abdomen with a toe kick, fighting back. Front face lock, elbow shot on the back of the head, bludgeon him. Front face lock again, and another elbow shot on the back of the head. Junction knows what he's doing. Irish whip bouncing Jacob Drake off the rope, but Jacob Drake stops it with a knee stop. Punch in the face, turns him around. Backslide cover from Jacob Drake. One, trying to steal it early. Two, no, it's not enough. Junction kicks out, and look at this little stare down from these two guys. I love it. Runs it on knee! Massive knee from Junction, not having any of it, taking Jacob Drake's head off. And look at this, rolling through with the leg scissors. Body weight, one. Two, he's going to steal it. Three, no, Jacob Drake kicks out. It's not enough. Jacob Drake, his Irish whipped into the corner by Junction, runs in for that body splash, but Junction is avoided by Jacob Drake. Irish whip throws him over the top rope. What's he got in mind? Jacob Drake is reversed by Junction. He fights back. Springboard crossbody. I love it. Pulls himself back into the ring and takes Jacob Drake out. Rolls him over. Gets the leg hooked for the cover. Can he put him away? That's one. That's two. That's three. No, it's not enough. Jacob Drake kicks out. Junction looking disappointed, but he knows he's got to stay on Jacob Drake. You know, Jacob Drake ain't a pushover, man. You know this. Irish whip bouncing Jacob Drake off the rope. Clotheslines him over the top rope. Oh, my God, with force. And here comes Hazard. And a little stare down from Hazard and Junction. Hazard finally getting back after being Blue Thunder bombed on the outside. But Junction reverses it. Irish whips him off the rope. Pulls the legs out. Nice leg pick. No! Hazard reverses it. Kicks him away. Hazard toe kick. Oh, he slapped him, man. He slapped him drop kick. And he knocks Junction off his feet. Hazard taking control now. Pulls the body down for the cover. That's one. And Junction kicks out on one. Love it. Not enough. Hazard, you got to do more, son. You got to do more. Picking Junction up to his feet. Hazard, big back elbow there. I felt that, man. But Junction's fighting back. Junction's fighting back. You can tell Junction wants this match more than anything, man. Irish whip off the rope. But Hazard blocks it with the knee lift. And oh, look at this tornado DDT. Oh, my God. wrenching the neck, using the body weight and momentum of Hazard to his advantage. But Junction gets his foot on the bottom rope, man. Ring awareness, ring awareness! Irish whip into the corner. Here comes Hazard, goes to punch him, but Junction moved and Hazard hit the turnbuckle cover and hurt his arm. And Junction is punishing for it, man. Junction is punishing him for it. Irish whip, what's he gonna mind? Draws it back elbow, nicely done! And then he takes his freaking head off his neck. But this time, Hazard gets the bottom rope. These guys know the ring, man. Ring awareness in full order here. Irish whip, Junction, clothesline over the top rope. Out goes Hazard. You can see Jacob Drake's recovering from that clothesline earlier on. He's getting back in the ring now. Hazard turn around. No! Junction scoops his legs out. Scoops his legs out. One. Jacob Drake scoops his legs out. Two. Scoops his legs out. Three. No! No, no! Junction reverses it, man. He kicks out just in time. But Jacob Drake is using this to his advantage. Kicks him down. Kick on the chest cavity. And a kick on the chest cavity again. Kicks him in the back of the head. Oh, my God. Vicious. Jacob Drake headlock takeover. Look at this, just wrenching the neck, trying to squeeze the air out of him like a toothpaste tube. Just trying to squeeze it, but Junction rolls him over out of desperation, but he's holding his head, man. That hurt him. Junction, oh, gets stamped. Gets stamped by Jacob Drake, and look at Drake just wearing Junction down now with his knee in the lower back and ribs. He's pointing at him. He's pointing at him. The crowd know Jacob Drake's in the lead in the driver's seat, and that's a dangerous place to be. Big suplex coming. Look at that strength of Jacob Drake. Oh, knee on the turret. Knee on the top of the head by Junction. He's fighting back. Knee lift. Junction runs in. Neckbreaker drop, and I love it. He takes him off his feet. Leg hooked by Junction. Put him away, Junction. Put him away. One. Two. No, Jacob Drake kicks out. It's not enough, but it was close, man. It was close. You can see Junction is really fighting this fight strong, man. Doesn't matter if it's Jacob Drake or if it's Hazard. Junction is really taking control of this match. Look at this. Look at this. Oh, my God. Reverse suplex. Oh, big move. Big move. Jacob Drake trying to roll away. He's feeling the effects of that. And Junction gets the leg hooked. One, two, three. No, it's not enough. Jacob Drake kicks out. I thought he had him, man. I thought he had him. I thought we had a new number one contender, but we don't. Jacob Drake now getting put into a suplex by Junction. Look at the strength of Junction. Lifting him up, stalling style. But Jacob Drake knees him in the top of the head. Reverses it. Snapmare from Jacob Drake. Off the rope with speed. With speed. Kick in the face. Big boot style. Oh my God. Took his head off. Jacob Drake for the cover. Lateral pin. That's one. That's two. And a kick out there by Jacob Drake. Kick out there by Junction. Sorry. It's not enough. Jacob Drake staying on the attack. What a great way to open the show so far, ladies and gentlemen. These guys going at it. Jacob Drake with his jab. Look at that little left jab. Caught him on the freaking nose. Put Junction into the corner. And look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Inverse reverse tornado DDT from Jacob Drake. Styled, man. Big style. One. Two. Three. Junction gets a shoulder up. It's not enough. Fans on their feet, man. That could put away a normal guy, man. But Junction ain't a normal guy. And Jacob Drake just punishing him in the corner with his strikes. Grabs the wrist. Irish whip. What's Jacob Drake got in mind? I see him eyeing him up. Runs in for the body splash, but Jacob Drake is dodged. But Junction runs in and he clotheslines, takes his head off. And here comes Hazard. What's Hazard doing, man? He's climbing up onto the top rope. What's he got in mind? Wait. Junction sit him. Oh my God, he throws him off with force. Crushing high down with the power of gravity. And Junction just throws Hazard out the ring. Dumps him out. Jacob Drake attacks. Junction in the back there. Forearm smash. And another one. Sling blade from Jacob Drake. Cutting down Junction to size. That's one. That's two. That's three. No, it's danger close. Danger close. Danger close. But Junction digs down into the fiber of his soul. Into the fiber of his being. And he finds a way to kick out. But Jacob Drake grabs him. Drops his head onto his knee. And a neck breaker there from Jacob Drake. How much punishment can a kid take, man? That's one. That's two. That's the way you know Junction gets a shoulder up again. Oh my God. Man, this is a great way to open the show. Tommy T. Thomas has done us a treat booking these three guys in a triple threat. But Jacob Drake and Junction going at it still. Irish whip into the corner. Jacob Drake goes for a splash again. Junction moves again. What's Junction got in mind? Grabs the wrist of Jacob Drake. Irish whips him into the corner. Here comes a forearm smash from Junction. And he's ready. Kick in the abdomen. Jacob Drake. Oh no, you put yourself in a bad position, Drake. You put yourself in a bad position. Springboard to the outside with a leg drop from Junction. Beautifully done, and I see him lining it up. Larasa, and he hits it, man. Rolls in. Respect to Eddie Guerrero for the one, for the two, for the three. Jacob Drake kicks out. Come on. Come on. The resiliency of Jacob Drake. My God, Junction torn and Jacob Drake up now. He knows he's got to hit him with something bigger. He knows he's got to hit him with something harder. But what's he got in mind? What's he got in mind? Kick to the abdomen. Fork in the road. Signature maneuver of Junction. And he's going up top. He's going high risk, man. He's going to go for a frog splash. He's going to go for a frog splash. But wait a minute. Here comes Hazard onto the apron. Hazard kicks Junction in the leg and Junction falls down. Hazard, oh my God, he pushes him off the top rope. And now Hazard going to the top. What's Hazard got in mind? Big body splash! Oh my god, and he lands on Junction for the cover to take the number one contendership. One, two, he's gonna get it. Three, Jacob Drake breaks the pin. Oh my god. So close, Jacob Drake clothesline and Hazard. He goes out the ring again. Hazard can't take a break, man. One, two, three, Jacob Drake. No, I thought he had it. I thought he was going to steal it off of that body splash from Hazard. But Jacob Drake, but Junction digs down deep into his soul again. And look at Jacob Drake just torn in the fans. Junction doesn't know where he is, man. He's dazed. He's confused. Forearm smash from Jacob Drake. Forearm smash again. And Jacob Drake going for it. Going for the sling bait. But Hazard ducks under the arm. Clothesline from Hazard. Clothesline from Junction. Mad Hatter drop, pulls out the legs, pulls out the legs. Oh, leg drop to the inside of the body. Oh, drop kick, basement style, dual piston style in the face. Put him away, Junction. Put him away. Become the number one contender. Become the number one contender. Kick to the abdomen. Fork in the road again for a second time. This is it. New number one contender. New number one contender. One, two, three. Jacob Drake kicks out. I don't believe it. Two fork in the road. Junction can't believe it. Wait a minute. Hazard springboard. Oh, he takes him out with a crossbody. Hazard gets out and comes back in every time. Hazard rolling Junction over. I don't believe it. Not like this. Hazard to become the number one contender. Two, three. Junction kicks out. Oh my god. And Jacob Drake just trying to crawl away after that fork in the road. And look, Hazard smells blood, man. Hazard sees an opportunity because Jacob Drake's trying to get up to his feet. And Hazard sees an opportunity. Like a shark, he smells blood. Hazard kick on Jacob Drake. He's going to put him away. New number one contender. He's going to put him away. That's a leg hook. That's one. That's two. That's three. Hell no. Junction breaks the pin. And Jacob Drake rolls out the ring in agony. And here comes Hazard clothesline on Junction. Hazard manhattan drop on Junction, and he pulls out the legs. Junction pushes him off with the strength of his legs, strong thigh muscle. Blue thunder bomb. No, Hazard backflips over it. Hazard slaps Junction, and Junction falls over and rolls out the ring. Wait, Jacob Drake with a schoolboy to now be a new number one contender for the internet championship. One, two, he's gonna get it. No, Hazard kicks out. Oh my god. And Junction getting back on the apron, trying to get in the ring. Jacob Drake drop kicks him off to the outside. Flat back bump on the solid floor. Hazard with a crucifixion cover for the pin. New number one contender. Two, three. Jacob Drake kicks out. Oh my god. Oh my god. Hazard picking Jacob Drake up. Drake break. No. Hazard pushes him away. Hazard kick. He hits him with a Hazard kick for the cover. That's one. For the cover, that's two. For the cover, three. I don't believe it. Hazard is a new number one contender for the XWF Internet Championship. What a match. What a match. Some people aren't going to be happy with that result, but you can't take that away from him, man. Hazard won that fair and square with the Hazard kick. You know, you've got to think, Jacob Drake took two fork in the rows on two Hazard kicks. He wasn't going to kick out. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. Wow, that's a great pre-show. Wow. Thank you so much for joining us, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get on with the show. See you on the other side. And now, XWF Presents Legacy. Ladies and gentlemen, that video package has told me everything that I need to know, and that is that tonight we are gonna make legacies and we are gonna break legacies. Let's take a look at tonight's lineup. So we're going to be opening the card with Penny Jacobs challenging Banshee for the XWF Women's Championship. And Penny has been obsessed with Banshee. She's been obsessed with that title. She's been obsessed with beating everybody that Banshee has beaten better and more efficiently. And she has proved she can do it. But can she beat Banshee tonight? Then we're going to have Luke Loins versus Brenda Nix. And Tommy T. Thomas said neither of these guys have got a match. He's going to put them together. They're going to go out there. They're going to light up the place on fire. And whoever comes out on top is going to be guaranteed a title shot, a title of their choice. Then we're going to have Tobias Upson versus Anso in a blood battle, man. This is a grudge match of sorts because Tobias Upson has grown up watching Anso. He has grown up watching YWE. He has used Anso for inspiration, but Anso took out Dr. Karn at Boiling Point. And Dr. Karn is another guy that Tobias Upson looked up to so much. Dr. Karn gave Tobias Upson his first ever match, and Upson cannot let this sit. Then we're going to see the immortal man known as Crow challenging Sean Savage for the XWF No Holds Barred Championship. And we know how good Sean Savage is. Do not scoff at Sean Savage. He stopped Tsunami. He stopped Dr. Karn. He's beaten Titus Valentine. He's beaten Junction. He's beaten loads of people for that title. But can he stop the unstoppable? Can he stop Crow? Then we've got another grudge match because the XWF Ceremonial Championship, which is currently vacant, will be decided. A new owner will take that belt when Riley Robin faces Treble in a match that has so much history because Treble put Riley Robin out for injury on Shockwave 46 when Riley Robin was rightfully the Ceremonial Champion. She won that gauntlet, man. She won that gauntlet, but Treble came out at the last second when she thought she'd won and took her out. And this is her chance to not only win that title, but to take out Treble once and for all. Then we're going to have a technical showcase because Mike Jacobs is going to challenge Reverend Al in a match for the Internet Championship, and this all goes on the line, man. Two of the greatest technicians this industry has ever seen will face off. And then main event time, Lord Lore, the Lethal Litigator, the most dominant wrestler in the history of this industry, faces the XWF Heavyweight Champion Damage, the guy that Lord Lore helped to create. Who will come out on top? But ladies and gentlemen, I'm hearing we're gonna start this show, so let's do it. Here's match, the opening match of the card, Penny Jacobs versus Banshee. A Penny is making her way down to the ring as she knows how good she is, man. You look at her face. She is not fazed by the fact that these fans are booing her. She is not fazed by the fact that she has to beat Banshee tonight to become the women's champion because Penny Jacobs knows how good she is, man. I've said it before. I said it again. All she does is radiate confidence. No one gets in this woman's head. No one tells this woman that she can't do something. No one tells this woman that she can't be dancing. And she believes wholeheartedly, 155,000% in the bottom of her gut, in the bottom of her heart, that she can be Banshee tonight and become the XWF Women's Champion. Now let me tell you about Penny Jacobs. For the last few shows, she has obsessed about the XWF Women's Championship. She has obsessed over Banshee. Any person that took Banshee's open challenge, Penny immediately challenged that person and beat them quicker and more efficiently than Banshee beat them. And she says that is her proof that she will beat Banshee tonight, because anyone that Banshee has beaten, Penny can beat them better. She can beat them faster. She can beat them stronger. And it's true. All you have to do is go back and watch the last few episodes of Shockwave. Anyone that challenged Banshee, Penny beat better. She beat quicker. She beat faster. And what sort of mind games does that play in the head of the XWF Women's Champion, Banshee? And if she's watching now, look at Penny Jacobs' face. No fear, no remorse. She has the blood of Jacobs' family running through her. We know how good that makes her. We've seen how good this woman is. Can she take the championship? I believe she can. But can Banshee defend the title? I believe she can. It's going to come down to who's the better girl on the night. And here she comes, the XWF Women's Champion, Banshee. The woman that won that title as the first ever XWF Women's Champion. She won it by winning the Women's Championship Tournament and defeating Athena in the final at XWF Boiling Point. and Banshee is coming down to the ring. She's ready, man. She's sporting the Legacy green, the colors, man. She's sporting the colors. But our color's gonna save you. Our color's gonna save you from Penny Jacobs. I don't believe colors are, but I believe Banshee's ability might just do so. Like I said, it depends who comes out better on the night. I think this could go either way. What a way to open the show. What a way to open the show. We already had an impressive triple threat match, and now we're onto the main card, and we're opening with the Women's Championship, and there's the title. Who are you voting for? Who's your money on? Who's your money on? I can't even vote at this point. I can't even put money on either of these two, but Penny Jacobs looks ready. Banshee holds the title up. No fear. She does not fear Penny Jacobs. Banshee is a fighting champion, man. Banshee is a fighting champion, and she will fight this to the end. Senior official showing Penny Jacobs what's on stake, what's on the line, and Penny looks ready. Banshee looks ready. And the senior official holds the Women's Championship above his head. And I say, let's get this show on the road. Both competitors looking ready. Both competitors looking ready, and they're going to lock horns. Can Banshee try and outchain Penny Jacobs? Penny Jacobs takes the wrist lock, takes a hold of the wrist. She's putting the pressure on. Oh, look at Banshee. Look at Banshee putting into a top wrist lock. She reversed it. Bit of chain technique here from Penny into a hammerlock slipping behind her. I wouldn't want to fight Penny in a chain battle, man. I wouldn't want to fight Penny in a chain battle. But Banshee's going for it. She's proven why she's the Women's Champion into a reverse armbar. And she's putting torque on that arm. Penny rolls out. Oh, and they go straight back in. Not even a stare down, just straight back into a lockup. Oh, Banshee slipping behind for a waist lock. She's got a hold of Penny. She's got a hold of Shifa. Slams her down. Wrestling takedown. I like this. Gut wrench style. Look at Penny pulling the chin. Lifting Banshee back up to her feet with a side headlock. Putting her weight on and just driving an elbow to try and wear down. Banshee and a hip toss inverse style. I said don't try and outchain Penny Jacobs. Penny grabs Banshee, Euro uppercut right in the jaw. Look at this, grabbing the wrist, Irish whip off the ropes, what she got in mind. Sleep there from Penny Jacobs, goes to grab the leg. Look at this, oh, Banshee spins around. I love it, into a wrist lock again. Holding Penny on the back of the head at arm's length. Twisting the arm, oh, Banshee with an elbow on the shoulder, an elbow joint there. Trying to grab her, Penny Jacobs pushes her away. Penny Jacobs, scoop, slam, no, Banshee slips over. Man, don't scoff at Banshee's technical ability. Irish whip from Banshee, what she got in mind, grabbing for a belly to belly. Look at the dead weight technique, of Penny Jacobs, and a club on the shoulder blades there, enough to stun you. Headbutts her! Penny Jacobs vicious. Oh, she scoops her up, wrestling takedown and slams her down. Big force. Lifting Banshee up to her feet and another headbutt. The aggressiveness of Penny Jacobs, man. These strike combinations. Twists the Irish whip in. Runs over. Look at this shoulder tackle. But Banshee moves out the way. And here comes Banshee. Going for a clothesline. No, drops her onto the top rope. Oh my God. Guillotine style. That's a game changer. That's a shift of momentum changer. And Penny Jacobs staying on the attack here. Scooping Banshee up again. Wrestling takedown. Just using her strength to her advantage. Which is this wrestling ability. And stamping on the back of Banshee. She's trying to get up to her feet. Penny Jacobs under the arm. Look at this. High angle back through blacks. Oh my God. Crushing her down with force, man. Banshee gets a foot on the bottom rope. Ring awareness. She knows what she's got to do. She's trying to get up to her feet. Penny Jacobs. Oh my God. She slapped her. The disrespect. Penny Jacobs knees in the face, oh my God. And this is where Penny Jacobs becomes dangerous, man, because she starts dismantling her opponents, and it's very, very, very difficult to fight back. But Banshee's doing it. She's fighting back, man. Oh, Penny Jacobs grabs the arm and deep arm drag there. Look at this. Front face, not European uppercut. Just shaking her head, but again, punch. Look at these strikes, man. Penny Jacobs kicked at her kneecap. She's wearing her down every single part of her body. Punch. Punch. Oh my God, Penny Jacobs. This is what I'm talking about. She's dangerous. Runs in, stamp on the chest cavity. And this is what I mean, man. She's like a vulture flying over a dead corpse, just picking the body dry. And that's what she's doing to Banshee right now. Banshee's got to find a way to come back from this. Because once you go down this alleyway, there ain't many ways to come back. But Banshee's fighting back. She's trying to fight back, at least. She's trying to fight back. But Penny Jacobs, belly to belly suplex. Oh my God, just like her father. That could be enough to put her away, but she ain't having it. She's staying on it. She's going for it more. Look at this. Penny Jacobs power. Oh my God. Powerbomb just picking Banshee to shreds. 1, 2, 3. Banshee gets a shoulder up. It's not enough. But that powerbomb, I mean, think of how that shakes your body. Think of what that does to your internal organs. Think of what that does to your skeletal structure. And Banshee's now got to fight that. She's got to fight that for the rest of this match. It's going to take effect. She's trying to get up. Oh, off the ropes and a knee to the side of the head by Penny Jacobs. 1, 2, 3. No, so close. But Banshee finds a way to dig down in her soul and kick out. She's a fighter, we know that. But Penny Jacobs is all over her like a rash and a kick to the back, soccer ball style. Stan, on the offense, goes to grab her. Banshee slips under the arm, kick to the abdomen. This is what she needs. No, a kick to the abdomen from Penny Jacobs and a big right hand. Banshee blocks it. She's fighting back. You can tell she's tired. You can tell she's dazed, but she's giving everything she's got. And there it comes. Spine buster, the signature move of Banshee. Fighting back with everything she's got. Leg hooks for the championship. That's one. That's two. She's going to put her away. No, a kick out on 2.5. It's not enough. And Penny still getting up to her feet like nothing happened. Banshee tries to grab her, but Penny throws her up. Throws her over with a fireman's carry. Irish whip draws her back. Banshee fights back with a toe kick. This is what she needs. This is the moment. It's just she needs calf kick. Penny trying to roll away, but Banshee smells weakness, man. And she's fighting back. Toe kicks her onto the ropes. Look at this. Grabs the leg. Throws her up to the outside, but Penny's holding on. Banshee off the ropes. Banshee spear through the ropes. Oh my God. And they both come crumbling to the outside. Oh my God, what a way to open the show. Banshee, gotta stay on her. Gotta stay on her, spearing her to the outside. I mean, that could be enough to put you away, man. That could be enough to retain the championship. Banshee gets the leg hook. That's one. That's two. That's three. Penny Jacobs kicks out on 2.9. Oh my God. She got speared off the apron to the outside. Come crushing down with cascading force of Niagara Falls. And she's still standing. Banshee off the rope. Pay dirt. Oh my God, dropping the face. Crash into the mat with megatons of force, and this could be it to retain the title. That's one. That's two. That's three. Penny Jacobs kicks out again, and look at Banshee's face. What do you gotta do to keep her down? What do you gotta do to keep this woman down? Banshee, it's gotta be running through her head right now. Penny's unlike anyone she's ever faced. Elbow shot in the back of the head, but she's still going. She knows she's just gotta keep wearing the body of Penny Jacobs down. Going for a third elbow, but Penny fights out with a knee and then a European uppercut with force. Taking the head off the shoulders, man. Taking the head off the shoulders. Grabbing Banshee. Banshee's fighting back. Neither of these two want to go down. Kick to the knee. Look at this. Banshee kick in the face. Oh, my God. And Penny Jacobs rolls out the ring from the force. And Penny's trying to get up to her feet. But look at Banshee. She's feeding off the fans. They're telling her to go for it. High risk. High risk. Banshee through the ropes. Oh, my God. Into the barrier. Oh, my God. And even Banshee's struggling to get up. High risk. High reward. But think of the damage, think of the wear and tear on Banshee's body as well as she rolls. And she rolls Penny Jacobs back into the ring. This is your opportunity, Banshee. This is your opportunity to retain the Women's Championship. That's one. That's two. That's three. No, Penny Jacobs kicks out again. Oh my God. What has Banshee got to do? What has Banshee got to do to keep Penny Jacobs down at Legacy? And here we go. Banshee with a clothesline. She's bringing the fight, man. Clothesline again. Banshee off the rope. Calf kick right in between the eyes. And Penny's down. And Banshee smells an opportunity. She sees an opportunity. Here it comes. Black Water. DDT. Penny catches her. Penny catches her. Power slam. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. She lands her down. Oh, no. Look at this. Python Plex. Not like this. Python Plex. Oh, my God. She hits the finishing move. She's going to take the XWF Women's Championship. Make a legacy for yourself. One, two, three. No, Banshee kicks out the Python Plex. What the hell? Look at Penny say she can't believe it. She can't freaking believe it. And the fans are cheering. They can't believe it either. But Penny's got to stay on the attack. Clothesline and another one. Hard clothesline. Banshee's trying to fight back, man. But she's still stumping that Python Plex. And it's here to world backbreaker. Oh, my God. Oh my God, and Penny punches Banshee, not like this, Extreme Tiger Suplex, and that's gotta be all she wrote, on her head, on her back, on her shoulders, the force, and Penny Jacobs gonna go for another Viperplex, another Pythonplex, and it's over, Pythonplex, Banshee fights back with a knee on the forehead, she's fighting back, no, goes for a lament, Penny Jacobs blocks it and pushes her away, a forearm smashes her with all the force of 1,000 tons, and Banshee doesn't know where she is, and Penny Jacobs Irish whips her into the corner, look at Penny, she's fuming, man, she can't believe that Banshee kicked out the Python. And now she's grabbing the arm of Banshee, and Banshee's stunned. She doesn't know where she is, and Penny's putting her on the top rope. What's she gonna go for? Look at these strikes, man. What's she gonna go for? Banshee kicks her in the face. She's fighting back. Banshee runs at her. Irish whips her into the corner. Here comes Banshee. Here comes Banshee. Monkey flip throws her with force. Bounce. Oh, big clothesline, big crossbody from the top rope. Springboard style. Banshee gets the leg hook for the cover. One, two, to retain the championship. Three, no. Penny gets her shoulder up again. What have you got to do? What a way to open the show. Irish whip into the corner from Banshee and a strike to the abdomen and another one. What has she got to do? A third one. And Penny drops down into the corner. Here comes Banshee. Sniper rifle clothesline. Kill shot. Kill shot. She's going to the top rope. She's going to the top rope. What's she going to go for? Cartwheel soap. No! Penny gets the knees up. and he gets the freaking knees up, and that could be a bad point. Not again, not again. Powerbomb, oh my god. Snapping her in half. Snapping her in half for the cover. One, two, she's put her away. Three, no, Banshee kicks out. Oh my god. How is this the opening match? How is this the opening match? These two women cementing a legacy tonight for sure. European uppercut. And you can tell Penny Jacobs is just fuming, man. Big right hand, and Banshee just crumbles. She can barely stand. She can barely stand. And Penny Jacobs, big clothesline. Oh my god. Just destroying Banshee. Just tearing a limb from limb, from shred to shred. Banshee fights back with a knee to the abdomen. She's trying everything she's got. Drop kick in the knee. Desperation. Desperation. Picking Penny up. Watch Banshee got in mind. Goes for the Irish whip, but Penny reverses it. These two going step for step, toe to toe. Punch to the face. Punch to the face again. Banshee reverses it. Throws Penny into the corner. Punch to the abdomen. Punch to the abdomen. And what's she doing? Grabs the arm. Penny's tired, man. Banshee's tired, man. They're both tired. And she's moving her to the top rope. And what's she doing? Banshee, what are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? Frankenstein! Oh my god! Oh my god, from the top rope. Listen to the fans. That's one. That's two. That's three. Penny Jacobs kicks out. Look at Banshee's face. Oh my god. How is this the opening match? This is main event caliber as far as I'm concerned. And Banshee's torn her up for a lament. This could be all she wrote. Lament. No, Penny pushes her away. Penny runs in through the schoolboy. Hooks the legs. Hooks the legs. One. Oh, the body weight, two, she's got it, three, no, Banshee kicks out on 2.9999999999999. And Penny for the Python Plex again, here it comes, no, knee to the head from Banshee, knee to the head from Banshee, she runs it up at a clothesline for Penny Jacobs, clothesline for Penny Jacobs again, Banshee goes for a clothesline under the arm, goes Penny Jacobs, here we go, Blackwater, DDT, and she hits it this time. She hits it this time, and Banshee's torning Penny up, she's torning her up, and if she hits this, it's lights out, lament on Penny Jacobs. To retain the championship. That's all she wrote. That's one. That's two. That's three. And Banshee puts Penny Jacobs away here tonight in Legacy. What a match. Wow. What a match. Wow. Look at that replay. That lament driving the skull and face of Penny into the canvas. And that was all she wrote. That was a one. That was a two. That, my friends, was a three. And Banshee retains the Women's Championship here tonight in an incredible match. You can't take anything away from Penny Jacobs. I mean, she took Banshee to her limit, no doubt. But Banshee proves that she is an incredible Women's Champion, and she's having a great first run with this title. What a big win. What a big win. Let's hear it up for Banshee. Incredible, man. Incredible from both these competitors. What a way to open the show. You know, if you're out the back, and you've got a match to come tonight, you've got to be thinking, how do we follow that? Because that is an incredible, incredible competition there from these two women. So much respect for both these women. So much respect for the XWF Women's Championship. So glad to have a women's division this strong here at XWF. Bear in mind that once upon a time, we didn't even have women wrestle here. So see them here delivering match quality like that. Big fan, man. Big fan, big fan, big fan, big fan, big fan. But ladies and gentlemen, this is just the start of the show. The still to come up next. We've got this match right here. Luke Loins versus Brendan X. And I believe we are moving straight onto that match, ladies and gentlemen. Straight onto that match. The winner will get to pick a title shot of their choice. It can be any of the titles. So if you guys are ready, well, I'm certainly ready. Let's kick Legacy back into gear. And we're going to move on to our next match. And here comes the guy, the man, Luke Loins. Luke Loins versus Brendan X, man, and we know how good Luke Loins is. Luke Loins is a one-time XWF World Heavyweight Champion. You know, this guy, he's had fights with some of the best in the damn company, and he's come out on top of most of them. You know, Luke Loins is an incredible athlete, and the thing about Luke Loins, and you're going to see this when he steps in the ring with Brendan X, is Luke Loins is a big guy, man. He's a strong, muscly guy, but he can work fast. And he's going to need to if he's going to fight Brendan X today, because we know how good Brendan X is, but we also know that his strong key abilities are his guile, his agility, man, his athleticism. So Luke Loins isn't going to be able to wrestle a heavyweight style match like he's used to when he's been defending his World Heavyweight Championship against the guys like, you know, A-Bomb and Lord Nightmare. He's gotta speed up. He's gotta keep his cardio high tonight, because he's gonna be facing a guy that's extremely fast on his feet, and that guy is this guy right here. Man, this entrance always gets me, man. You know, look at this, man. I'm feeling it, Luke Loins. versus Brendan X. This is going to be competitive, man. I'm telling you, you guys aren't ready for this. I know it's going to be good. Luke Loins and Brendan X, man. I wasn't expecting this. Like, I had no idea this was going to get booked for the card tonight. But let's make a legacy. Let's build a legacy. That's what Tommy T. Thomas said, and here he is. Brendan X sporting that awesome friggin' mask and coat, man. I'm digging it. Very unique individual, this guy. Very unique individual. If you want to check out more of his stuff, you need to go see him. He's wrestling all over the place at the moment. He's wrestling on OCW. He's wrestling on EWF. He's wrestling more and more places. I'm not going to list them all because I'll be here all day, but he's wrestling all over the show, man. So he's getting experience fighting very good guys. He's getting experience fighting big guys, small guys, fast guys, powerful guys. You know, he's learning the tricks of the trade, and he's got to apply everything that he's learned tonight. He's got to apply it all tonight against Luke Loins, because Luke Loins is one of the best we got in XWF, man. Pound for pound, he's one of the best guys we've got. So, Brendan, you got your work cut out for you, man, but remember, the pay-per-view is called Legacy. And the legacy that comes from winning this match is that the winner will get a shot at any title of their choice. And I'm telling you now, if Luke Loins wins this match, he will go for the World Heavyweight Championship. But if Brendan X wins this match, will he go for the World Heavyweight Championship? We've seen him face damage for it once before. We saw him on his debut, he faced damage for the World Heavyweight Championship. Will he go for another shot at that? Depending on who wins tonight, it'll be damage or Lord Lore. Will Brendan go straight to that world championship, or would he go for a smaller title? You know, and work his way up. The Internet Championship, you could win that, get 10 defends, and cash it in. That could almost be worth more than cashing straight in for the world championship, but that depends on the individual. You know, Brendan X has got the credibility to go for any of the titles as far as I'm concerned. So, let's see what we're going to do. Let's see what we're going to do. Brendan X, Luke Loins. I'm interested to see how this plays out. Luke Loins with a front face lock, goes for a European uppercut. Brendan fights back with the knee. Luke Loins pushes him back and just gives him a little jab on the chest, goes for a line, but Brendan X is fast, man. Grabs Luke Loins around the back of the head and kicks him, gets kicked in a toe kick in the abdomen by Luke Loins. Runs in. Oh, scissor sweep, drop toe hold. Now look at the size difference, man. Look at the size difference. Brendan's a lot smaller than Luke Loins in size, weight, height, everything. Muscle mass, the whole shebang, but we know that Brendan X can fight guys bigger than him, man. We've seen him. He's like the ultimate underdog. Irish whip there from Luke Loins into the corner. Grabbing Brendan X. Big scoop slam onto the shoulders. Luke Loins is reversed into a reverse DDT there from Brendan X. Nicely executed from Brendan X. Man, I think these two guys are going to go at it. European uppercut there from Brendan X. And another one. And Luke Loins falls back into the corner. Brendan X goes to grab him. Luke Loins gets a boot up. Grabs the arm. Big Irish whip with strong force. Now Luke Loins runs in. Big clothesline. Pulls him out. Bulldog into the center of the ring from Luke Loins. And he's going to go for an early cover with the leg hooked. That's one. That's two. And a kick out there on two by Brendan X. It's good, but it's not good enough. It's close, but it ain't no cigar. Grabbing him by the back of the head, lifting him up to his feet. Look at this, Luke Loins puts him in. Look at that strength of Luke Loins. This big, big stalling suplex on Brendan X. This is where Luke Loins can use his size advantage, man. Big suplex for the one. For the two. Brendan gets a shoulder up, but think how much damage that suplex is going to do to your body as this match goes on, man. You've got to consider that. Big move. Irish whip there from Luke Loins. What's he got in mind? Sleep there from Luke Loins. Playing the fast game, man. He can play the fast game just as much as you want. But now he's slowing Brendan down. He's putting his body weight on that top wrist lock to wear him down. But Brendan's fighting back. Fist to the abdomen. Third one. This is Brendan's opportunity. Goes for a punch. Luke Loins blocks it and knees him in the abdomen. Luke Loins got an answer for everything. Oh, he goes for a step up Enziguri. But Brendan's speed advantage dodges it. And a nice modified net breaker there from Brendan X. Leg hooks for the cover. That's one. That's two. No, a kick out just before the two. And you got to think what's going through Brendan's head, man. Luke Loins kicks out just before the two of that modified net breaker. Brendan staying on the attack as he lifts Luke Loins up. But Luke Loins with a deep arm drag. Goes for a forearm smash. Brendan blocks it. Oh, look at this combo from Brendan. That's what you need. The speed advantage, man. The speed advantage runs in and pulls the head down. Nicely executed. Brendan using speed, cunning, agility, guile. Using everything in his playbook. One. Two. Kick out just before the two there, or was it on the two? I'm not sure. Either way, it was dangerously close to two, but that's not dangerously close to three, my son. Brendan staying on the attack with these nice strikes. I mean, these strikes are working effective. Spinning back fist there. Luke Loins leaning on the rope. Irish whip from Brendan. What's he got in mind? Sling blade from Brendan X. Cutting Luke Loins down to size again. Leg hook for the cover. Keep wearing him down with these covers. One. Two. Because even if you kick out of a pin, the force that you exerted to lift your shoulders up, to lift your body up, is wearing down on your cardiovascular energy. Luke Loins going for a clothesline too slow, but they caught him with a second one. Brendan X didn't see that second one coming, man. He tried to avoid the first. Second one came out of nowhere. DDT from Luke Loins. Right on the top of the head of Brendan X. That's hard, man. One. Two. 3, Brendan kicks out. Brendan kicks out. Did you see the way he kicked his legs to get the momentum? That's because Luke Loins weighs reasonably amount more than Brendan X. And look at Luke Loins going for a sleeper hold, dragging Brendan down to the floor. Brendan, look at this, grabbing the toe. Brendan grabbing the feet, pulls it over. Brendan flips over, man. Nice. This guy, I told you, he knows his deal. He knows the deal. Runs it, go. Big clothesline for Brendan X, catching Luke Loins as he was getting up to his feet. And Brendan X grabs the leg for the cover again. That's one. That's two. And these guys really wearing each other down with these covers, man. They both know the game. They both know how this playbook works, man. They both know what they got to do. Brendan X lifting Luke Loins up to his feet. Look at this. Grabs him in. Oh, look at that hatch suplex. Nicely done from Brendan X. Think of the damage that's going to do to you. The wear and tear on your body, man. Grabbing him. He's going to go for it again. Wait, Luke Loins spin him around. Oh, he slams him down with the arm. You ain't doing that again, boy. You ain't doing that again. And now Luke Loins peppering Brendan X with these strikes. Look at these, man. Double axe handle on the back of the head again, using the size and strength advantage that he holds over Brendan X against him. Irish whip into the corner. Luke Loins runs in, grabs the head, and look at this. Luke Loins lifting himself up onto that second rope, grabbing the arm over. Look at this, pull over suplex. Oh my god, centrifugal suplex there. Luke Loins looking a bit tired from that, but think of the damage that that's going to do to Brendan X, man. For the cover, could it be over? 1, 2, 3, Brendan X kicks out. It's not enough. 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 You gotta keep fighting, man. You gotta keep fighting. Luke Loins, you gotta do more to Brendan X, man. I told you, he ain't gonna be a pushover. Now Luke Loins just peppering him with strikes. Irish whip bouncing him off the ropes. Once he got in mind, goes to that Luke Loins back elbow, but Brendan X moves and kicks him in the abdomen under the arm. Luke Loins ready for a close up Pele kick. Brendan using that speed advantage, man. I told you from the day one. I told you from the start of the match. That's what Brendan's got to use. He's got to outspeed Luke Loins. Luke Loins throws him over the top. Brendan with the back elbow to the face. Luke Loins falls into position. Oh, Brendan sees an opportunity. Round the ring post, and he kicks him in the face. Big move from Brendan. Big move from Brendan. Springs him with the legs, man. Leg drop right in the face of Luke Loins. Put him away, man. That could be enough. Leg hook from Brendan. That's one. That's two to pin Luke Loins. That's three. No, Luke Loins kicks out on 2.8, 0.5, 0.9, 0.7. To be precise. Brendan with a stamp on the abdomen. You know, you can feel the frustration boiling in both these men. They respect each other. But they gotta keep digging. And what a knee strike. Open hand palm strikes and a knee. And Luke Loins rolls out the ring to try and recover from that. I mean, imagine how much that shakes you. Here comes Brendan. Here comes Brendan. 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 Step up tope. Oh my god. And he takes Luke Loins out hard, man. On the outside. Big dive. Big dive. Big dive. What a move. Brendan going back to the ring. No, wait a minute. Springboard to the outside. A side moonsault. Just as Luke Loins was getting up to his feet. Brendan using every move in his repertoire to take down Luke Loins. He knows what he's got to do, man. He knows what he's got to do, and he's using the high risk. He's using the high risk like Brendan does. That's what he does, man. For the cover, leg hooked. That's one. That's two. That's three. No, Luke Loins kicks out the step up, tope, and an aside moonsault. And it ain't enough to put him away. You gotta do more, Brendan. You gotta do more. You gotta keep fighting. European uppercut, and he's gonna go for it, man. Brendan throwing everything he's got. Big forearm. Look at Luke Loins. He's shook, man. He's shook from these moves. Brendan goes to grab him. Luke Loins throws him over the top. Brendan holds on. Oh, no. Oh, no. He punches him. Signature. Luke Loins move. DDT rope hung. Look at the head and neck of Brendan X crushed like a freaking soda can. Just crushed into oblivion. Leg hooked for the cover. That's one. That's two to put Brendan X away. That's three. No, Brendan X kicks out the rope hung DDT. Oh, my God. Oh, believe this. What a match from these two. What a match from these two. And Luke Loins pulling Brendan X to the center of the ring. What's he got in mind? Oh, my God. Vintage Luke Loins. We haven't seen this for a while. We haven't seen this for a while. The figure four leg lock. And he's applying the pressure. And Brendan's in the center of the ring. He's got nowhere to go. He's got nowhere to go. Look at Brendan in agony, man. And Luke Loins applying the torque, applying the pressure of a figure four leg lock. And you don't know the pain, man. I've been in one of these before. Your knees are bending in ways that they are not designed to be bent, man. They are bending in ways that they should never bend. And the pain just spiking through your legs, through your nerve endings, it's unfathomable, man. It's unfathomable. And Brendan X can't stay in this hold for too much longer, man. He's gonna have to tap out. He's gonna have to tap out or risk having no legs for the rest of his damn life, man. Because this move is gonna tear the ligaments. But Brendan X is pulling over. He's pulling over and he's turned the polarity of the move. And now Luke Loins is in agony, so he lets go. He lets go. And they're both trying to get up to their feet. They're both trying to get up to their feet. Brendan X clothesline. He takes the head of Luke Loins off out of desperation. Out of desperation, and Brendan X lifting Luke Loins up. Luke Loins goes for a clothesline. Pele kick again. The speed advantage of Brendan X as he picked Luke Loins up to his feet. What's he got in mind? Irish whip into the corner. Here he comes, and he pulls Luke Loins out. Bounce, bounce. Big crossbody from Brendan X. And this is the momentum that he needs. This is the energy that he needs as he stamps on Luke Loins and he's starting to feel that fire burn in his soul. Luke Loins to hell of back! No! Fights back with an elbow and a third one. Brendan saves from certain death, goes for an execution, but Luke Loins, he pushes him away, and as he runs in, he power slams him to hell. He power slams him to hell, and Luke Loins now with force. Big clothesline and a second one. Brendan trying to definitely get up to his feet, misses the clothesline. Luke Loins, pop it, bop, big drop kick, bop, bow. Bang, bam, wallop. Luke Loins off the rope. Signature knee, but Brendan scouts it. He sees it coming. He's been watching the tape, man. He's been watching the tapes, and he runs at Luke Loins, and the Irish whips him into the corner. What's he got in mind? Grabbing the Irish whip again, but Luke Loins reverses it this time. Brendan X backflips over him too fast. Speed advantage under the clothesline. Brendan X after all, elbow in the face. Oh, my God, and he takes Luke Loins down with force, man. With force, and Brendan's starting to feel that energy. Goes for an execution again, but Luke Loins runs in and clotheslines him and cuts all that momentum. Dead stop. Like hitting the brick freaking wall, like hitting the freight train. And Luke Loins with the Irish whip is going to go for a power slam again. No, Brendan's trying to twist it. Luke Loins twisted back out of it into a smaller drop. The reversals, man. The reversals. Five reversals in the space of 3 seconds. And Brendan X going for an execution again. But Luke Loins ducks it. To hell and back. Brendan's fighting back. Man, these guys want to hit their finishing moves so much because this will be the end of the match. And Brendan X grabs the arm. Luke Loins reverses it. Brendan X has the arm. Oh my God. Oh my God. Springboard freaking backflip Pele. I don't believe it. And Brendan X kicks him down and he pops him up. Brendan X, long blower, power bomb, long blower, power bomb, long blower. And he sees a weakness, he sees a target, he's waiting for it. Here it comes. Execution on Luke Loins. He hits the finisher to put away Luke Loins for the one, for the two, for the three. And Brendan X defeats Luke Loins here tonight to build a legacy at Legacy. And wow, what a match. What a match. Brendan X just put himself on the XWF map, man, by beating Luke Loins. And look at Brendan, he's fired up, man. He's feeling that big victory, that biggest victory that Brendan X has had since he's come here to XWF. What a win. What a win for this guy. I'm looking forward to seeing which belt he's going to challenge for, man. Because he gets a choice now. That's what Tommy T. Thomas said. Brendan X having his hand held up by the ref. And look, Luke Loins, man, up to his feet. Look at Luke Loins, hands on his waist. And he's saying, you got me, man, you got me. He's saying, you got me fair and square. What's hand out for the handshake, man. Brendan X shakes it. Advocating Brendan X from Luke Loins, man. Wow, what a match. I'm big on that, man. I'm big on the respect as well, because Luke Loins, you know, he didn't have to do that. He didn't have to come in and admit his loss. Either way, up next, ladies and gentlemen, is Tobias Upson versus Antho. And I do believe that we've got a video package for this one. So we're going to take a look at that in just a second. Wait a minute. Mugger grabs Luke Loins. He's getting out the ring. Brendan X has already left. Luke Loins was just paying attention to the fans. And Munger's just attacked him. He's not even on the freaking legacy card. What's Munger doing? Grabbing Luke Loins. Listen to the fans, man. They ain't happy with this. Munger, oh my God, just throws Luke Loins into that ring post with force. What's Munger doing? Grabs the head. Not again. Oh my God. Luke Loins crumbles down. He's just worked a hard match, man. What are you doing, Munger? You ain't even on the card. I think that might have something to do with it, though, because Munger ain't happy. He's been on the last two CPV cards. He ain't got a match tonight. And he's coming out here and just picking apart a Luke Loins. Oh, no. Bicep of God on Luke Loins. Oh, my God. The force. People don't get up from that. And look at Munger just kneeling over Luke Loins. Just looking at his handiwork. Just looking at his handiwork. And Luke Loins don't know where he is, man. Luke Loins don't know where he is. He's just laying there. And Munger's leaving, and the fans just not happy, man. Not happy with that show of force from Munger. And now he's walking away. He is walking away, and he's cocky and arrogant about it. That's the worst thing. He's leaving. Wow, okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to move on. We got a video package. Check this out. Ladies and gentlemen, this is it. We're moving on to our next match, and if that video package didn't demonstrate how much emotional weight there is on the line for this guy right here, Tobias Upson, then I don't know what to tell you. You must have a heart of freaking stone, because Tobias Upson just wore his heart on his freaking sleeve, and over the last few shows, since Boiling Point, he has been calling out Anto at any opportunity, because he wanted a match with him so he could put this right. So he could get Anto back for what he did to Dr. Karn at Boiling Point. And now he's got his chance, man. Now he's got his chance here tonight at Legacy. And like he said in that video package, he fights for the legacy of Dr. Karn. He fights for the guy that gave him an opportunity when no one else out the back would give that little freaking kid with blue hair and a blue top a chance. And Dr. Karn gave him one. More than one. Because Dr. Karn is always looking out for the future of XWF, and here we go. Here we go. The man that he has to fight. A guy that he looked up to in YWE. A guy that he looked up to when he was starting out in this wrestling industry, in this company. And accompanied to the ring by that little weasel, Johnny Extreme, is Anto, a legend, an icon, just like Tobias Upson said in that package. Anto's been and done and seen it all, man. One of the greatest. And I can't imagine what is going through Tobias Upson's head right now. Put yourself in his position. Imagine fighting one of your heroes, a guy that you looked up to for years, a guy that literally was a part of the reason that you got in that wrestling ring. Imagine the anger and frustration. Imagine the emotions that are going through this kid's head. Man, this is going to be a heated one. This is going to be a heated one. And I got to tell you, Tobias Upson, don't underestimate him. He's beaten some great guys, but Anto's accolades, his history, like Upson said in the package, it dwarfs him. And it does. And Anto looks extremely cocky, and Johnny Extreme just following him around, just nodding. Look, he's such a these guys, man. Oh, if I could get in the ring and beat these guys up, I would, but I wouldn't want to test that, man. I'm not saying I can't fight. I can fight, but I can't fight these guys, man. Let's get this show on the road. Tobias Upson versus Anto at XWF Legacy. Upson goes for a kick. Anto blocks it. Knees, elbows on the knee joint. And look at these vicious strikes. Anto just hacking away, hacking away, hacking away. Oh my gosh. So block in the corner. And another one. Upson falls down, man. He's overwhelmed, but he strikes. Anto just stamping on that chest. Look. Oh my god. I mean, you could cave in the chest like that, man. Oh my god. Look at Anto just walking around so cocky. So, oh my god. Drops a knee on the back of Upson's head. This ain't looking good for Upson early on, man. This ain't looking good for Upson early on. And look at Anto. And oh my god, a vicious DDT. Swiping through with it. And Anto just taunting to the fans, and they're booing him. They're booing him. Upson trying to get up to his feet, man. Johnny Extreme just watches on. And look at this, Anto. Not again, DDT. No! Upson fights out with a knee to the abdomen. He's throwing these wild strikes. He's throwing these wildest strikes. He's fighting with all he's got. Irish whip off the ropes. What's up? He's got in mind. He uses a sleep. Upson, look at this. Oh, Anto trying to reverse it. Upson, oh, nice arm drag. Pulls him through. And there was it. Oh, my God. Big clothesline from Upson. Taking Anto off his knees there. And Upson for the cover. Leg hook. That's not even a one. Look at that. Look at Upson's face, man. And Upson getting, Anto getting straight back up to his feet. Upson trying to grab Anto, but he's fighting back. Look at this big strike across the head, kick to the abdomen. Anto just wearing Upson down with these strikes, man. Just throwing them viciously. Look at this. Look at this. Anto, oh, pulls him out. Slams the face down. Oh, my God. Vicious move from Anto with the force, man. With the force, just whipped his neck and slammed him down. And Anto just driving a knee into the ribs. And the thing with Anto, look how cocky he is. He's just playing with him, man. He's just playing with his food. Oh my god, hip toss neckbreaker! Johnny Extreme just loving this, man. Anto, and oh, drops a knee and elbow right on the face, calculated, of Tobias Upson. Picks him up to a knee position, just stamps on his face. Oh my god. Like I said, Anto's just playing with his food at this point, man. This is vicious. Look at this front face lock, grabbing the head of Tobias Upson, and he slams his face into the turnbuckle. Oh my god. Oh my god. And what's Anto doing? Hooks the head under the arm. What's he doing, man? Suplex up the second rope. Oh my god. This is an assault, man. This is a brutality for the cover. One, two, is it over? Three, no, Upson gets a shoulder up. He's still got fight in the kid. But he's definitely being drowned right now by the icon. That is Anto. And look at Anto turning Upson down, turning him Upson around. Oh my god, and slams him down with a beautiful neckbreaker, to put it put it bluntly, stamps all over him, man. Ethel just wearing down on Upson, man. Upson doesn't know where he is. What's up? What's he doing now? Look at this. Upson doesn't know. Oh, he rolls him through forward. This is your chance, kid. This is your chance. You got to fight back. What you got in the tank, man? What you got in the bank? Kick to the knee. Super kick in the face. Nice one. Upson for the desperation cover. Can he put Antho away? That's one. Kick out just after the one, man. Antho so resilient. I mean, we've seen it across so many promotions. Upson running. Oh, nice arm drag. Pulls Antho through straight up to his feet. Upson tries to run at him, but Antho spins him out the way and spears him. Oh, my God. No matter what Upson does, Antho just hacks away at him, man. Oh, not again. Not again. Another DDT. Oh, my God. Imagine what that's doing to the spinal column. Imagine what that's doing to the vertebrae of Tobias Upson. Spinning a heel kick by Antho. Vintage Antho. Vintage Antho. For the cover. One. Two. Three. Upson fights out. The kid's still got fire in his soul. The kid's still got fire in his heart. Antho, you're going to have to kill this kid if you want to put him down, man. You're going to have to kill him because he's going to keep fighting the legacy of Dr. Karn in his veins. But a headlock takedown there from Antho. And this is brutal, man. This is brutal. I wasn't expecting such a one-sided beatdown. But Anto's just wearing Upson down, man. And the fans don't want to see this. Anto, what are you doing? What are you doing? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. He put his head and neck behind the rope and ripped the arm through, man. One, two, three. No. The crick of the neck of Tobias Upson. I mean, that's long-term damage. That's vicious from Anto. Using the freaking ring as a weapon. Look at his normalized suplex. Oh, my God. This is hard to watch. Antho just torn into the fans, and they're just boiling down on him. Look at him pointing to the head like he knows exactly what he's doing, and he's calculated. And Upson can't get a fence in, man. This is hard to watch. Now, Upson's so vigilant, man. He's trying to crawl up to his feet. What the hell? Antho picked him up, and Upson's just laughing and pointing at him. He's just pointing at him. Upson, oh, Antho wasn't even expecting that. Double axe handle on a second one. Oh, he rolls him through. Listo kick, and Antho goes up into the corner. He's shook from that, man. Antho wasn't expecting Upson to just get straight back up. Oh, the signature maneuver. Upson, bionic bulldog on Antho. Antho hit him with a Northern Light suplex. He picked him up, and Upson just started laughing and pointing at him. Antho was shook, man. I don't think he'd... Dr. Lock! Oh, Tobias Upson using the signature maneuver of Dr. Karn against Antho. He's using the Dr. Lock, and he's wrenching it in. Imagine if he can make him tap out to the Dr. Lock. No, knee to the head, and knee to the head again from Antho. And Antho runs it with the schoolboy to put Upson away, to put him away here tonight. A legacy. One, two, three. Upson kicks out. It's not enough. Antho must want to put this away now, and here we go, forearm smash. Antho runs in with a clothesline. This could be it. Look at this. Four now, some face buster on Tobias Upson. He fought hard, but Antho's going to put him away, and if he hits the AKO, this could be over. Antho punches and turns him around. Oh, no. No. Argentine. Backbreaker. No, oh, my God. Imagine what that does to your lungs. Argentine lung blower, man. One. Two, it's over. Three, Upson kicks out the signature maneuver of Antho. What the hell? This kid is digging down deep, man. He's taking a freaking beating, but he's digging down deep, and Anto's getting frustrated now. Anto's getting frustrated because he's just stamping on him. And look at this, dragging Upson by the arm to the center of the ring. What's he going to do? Antho drops an elbow right bluntly on the forehead of Tobias Upson. And now Antho, look at this. What the hell? What a submission. Look at this, pulling the wrist. You're going to snap the freaking guy's arm, Antho. Look at this, applying the pressure. Look at Upson's face, man. He's in agony. He's going to have to submit. The referee's asking him, do you quit? And Antho's bending that arm in a way that it should never bend. And I'm telling you now, that elbow joint will snap if Upson does not submit. Because Antho's not holding back. He's putting the knee in. He's pulling back. He's putting torque on it, man. Upson rolls out. He rolls out somehow out of desperation. Antho runs in. Oh, my God. Spear. As Antho tried to come at him, Upson hit him with a spear. And Upson elbow drop off the ropes. Antho holding his throat. He hit him right in the throat. Upson off the ropes again. Winding the arm. A second elbow drop from Tobias Upson. He's fighting back. He's digging down. He's gliding back. He's picturing Dr. Karn in his head. And he runs over and swings the arm. And another elbow drop on Antho. This is your chance, Tobias Upson. You've never had a better chance than this right here in this match at Legacy. Torn in. Antho up. Tobias Upson hooks the arm. He's going to go for an acid trip. No. No. Ezo reverses it and clotheslines out the signature maneuver. Out the signature maneuver. Oh, Tobias Upson rolls through with a schoolgirl. Pin him. One. Make history. Make a legacy. Two. Three. No, Antho kicks out. It's not enough. But Antho doesn't expect that, man. He's holding his head. Oh, Tobias Upson with a double axe handle. And another one. He's fighting for it. Listo kick. No. He was going to go for that schoolboy. But Antho clotheslined him. He scattered it. It's not. AKO. No! No, the leg hook from Anto, that's one! That's two! That's three, and that's all she wrote. Anto puts Tobias Upson away here tonight at Legacy. He fought, man. Upson fought with every fiber of his being, but tonight it wasn't good enough to beat a legend. It wasn't good enough to beat an icon. It wasn't good enough to beat a guy that he's looked up to for his entire career. And Anto's out of breath, man. I think that was a harder fight than he was expecting, but he does come out on top here tonight at XWF Legacy. You know, there was moments there where Anto was all over and like a rash, but Upson fought, man. Upson bent down. I think he gave him a better run for his money than he was expecting. I'm proud of the kid, man. What's Johnny Extreme doing? Upson's trying to get up to his feet on the outside. Oh my god, a chair shot to the back from Johnny Extreme. What are you doing, Johnny? What are you doing, man? Just leave him be. Just leave him be. And Johnny Extreme picks it up, Upson up and rolls him back in the ring, and he's grabbing that chair and looking at Anto just watching. Look at Anto just watching. Johnny Extreme, oh my god, another chair shot across the back. Oh my god, this is vicious. Team Canada, stop it. Stop what you're doing. I don't want to see a repeat of Boiling Point, but Johnny Extreme putting Tobias Upson's head in that chair. What are you doing, man? Anto up on the ropes, taunting. The fans booing. Upson's trapped, man. He can't move. He's stuck in that chair. And Johnny Extreme's gone to the top rope, and Anto just watching on. Upson's just unconscious, man. He doesn't really know what's going on. He's half asleep, and Anto just leaning over him and looking at him. Looking at him. What'd he say to him? I didn't hear it. Johnny Extreme, oh my god, just jumped off onto that chair with the knees. Oh my god, I think he could snap his freaking neck. He could break his freaking windpipe. And Team Canada are just taunting and cheering at their handiwork. What in the blue hell are these freaking guys doing? That's disgusting. What you did at Boiling Point to Dr. Colin was sickening. And what you just did to a kid who just put his heart on his sleeve and fought with every fiber of his being against you, Anto. And you and Johnny Extreme do that, and Anto's leaving. And now Johnny Extreme's leaving, and Anto's just waiting for him. They're leaving. Just leaving a broken Tobias Upson in the ring. And listen to the fans just booing down on these guys, man. And the fans looking on at the ring, worried, concerned for Tobias Upson. And look at Team Canada just winding the fans up, just taunting there. You guys sicken me. You guys freaking sicken me. And they're leaving. Here at Legacy, man, this was supposed to be about building a legacy. That ain't how you build a legacy. That is how you ruin a freaking legacy of Team Canada, and that's disgusting. Ladies and gentlemen, up next, we will have the No Holds Barred Championship on the line. Crow versus Sean Savage. And that is happening right now. Let's do it. And ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Making his way down to the ring is the XWF No Holds Barred Champion. And his name is Sean Savage. And we know how good Sean Savage is, man. Sean Savage won that No Holds Barred Championship before XWF went on hiatus. And since we came back, he has defended that belt over and over again against some great talent. And he has proved to be arguably the most dominant No Holds Barred champion we have ever seen in the company. And if he isn't, he's definitely up there with the best of them. Definitely up there with the best of them. But tonight, he fights a guy that could be described as not human. He fights a guy that could be described as immortal. He fights a guy that could be the most dangerous challenge for his title yet. And that guy's name is freaking Crow. And these guys have they've butted heads over the last few shows multiple times. Since Tommy T. Thomas showed up with his XWA guys, Crow has got the better of Sean Savage multiple times, and then Sean Savage got the better of him when he slammed his head in a freaking car door. With no rules, man, I'm scared of what these guys are gonna do to each other. I'm scared of what these guys are gonna do to each other. I am scared of what Oh boy, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. XWF Legacy. Here we go. It's the atmosphere's dropped, man. The atmosphere's dropped, and I know Sean Savage ain't scared of much, but something's gotta be playing on your mind when you see all this weird stuff going on, and there he is. There is Crow. And let me tell you, man, Crow is one of the most resilient men I have ever seen in my freaking life. I've seen this guy take damage to his body that no man should be able to survive. I've seen this guy get up from stuff that no man should ever be able to get up from. I don't know how he's wired. I don't know what is wrong with his pain threshold in his freaking body. But I've never seen anything like this guy. It was only a few shows ago, Damage hit him with the brain damage, and Crow literally sat up a second later. And just stood up and looked Damage in the frickin' eyes, and Damage looked like he'd seen a ghost, because brain damage, people don't get up from brain damage for weeks, for days, for hours, depending on who you do it on. Crow stood straight up, man. Crow stood straight up. I've seen this guy take a chair shot around the fucking head and get straight up. I've seen weird stuff from this guy, man. Like I say, some people say he's immortal. Crow is dangerous, and a no-holds-barred match is right up Crow's street. For the no-holds-barred championship, I truly, truly believe that if Sean Savage doesn't wrestle to the absolute best of his ability, to the absolute very frickin' best, Crow's gonna take that belt off him tonight at Legacy. I believe it. You haven't seen what I've seen. Aiden Black Crow. A dangerous man. Sean Savage holds the title up and he looks cocky, man. He's always got a sense of arrogance about him. He's always got a sense of confidence about him, and sometimes that plays into the strengths of Sean Savage. But could that be a downfall tonight against Crow? I don't know. I don't know. I've told you now, Sean Savage is one of the most dangerous men on the roster. You know, we've seen him beat Dr. Carr, and we've seen him beat Tsunami, among others, when he's been defending that championship. Can he defend it against Crow tonight? Look at these two just staring each other down. Crow ain't scared. Sean Savage ran in. Crow kneed him in the abdomen. Look at these wild strikes from Crow, like mini bricks being thrown at your head. Grabs a wrist. Irish whip from Crow. Goes for a kick. Savage catches it. Oh, Crow pushes him back. I love it. Crow front face lock, goes for an elbow. Savage knees him in the abdomen. Pulls the arm. Crow turns it around. Slaps it. Kick, toe kick in the abdomen. Crow, big slap on the chest, and another one light in the chest up of Sean Savage. Irish whip from Crow. What's he got in mind? Goes to grab him, but Sean Savage punches him. Oh, shoulder block from Crow. Oh, he didn't block that one. Sean Savage torn in. You know, Sean Savage tried to shoulder block him. Crow stayed on his feet, and then Sean Savage just drove through him with force, man. And look at this. Sean Savage headbutt, and Crow goes down. This is where Sean Savage gets more dangerous. I mean, you can tell. There's a size difference, man. Crow is smaller than Sean Savage. Savage has got a lot more weight on him, but Crow's a fighter, man. Look at this. Throwing Sean Savage against the rope with these kidney stone-like forearm smashes. Sean Savage goes down. Crow, don't matter how big you are, man. Crow says it don't matter. Look at him holding the arm and stamping on the back. Oh, my God. This is a kick in the face from Crow. He's a violent man. This is what I'm saying, man. There's no conscience in Crow. Hammerlock with his foot on the back. And look, this bend in the arm. Joint manipulation on the fingers. Let's go. They all just knee in the back. Oh, my God. Sean Savage, you never fought anyone like Crow, man. One. Kick out of one there by Sean Savage, showing his resiliency. But Crow is a violent individual, punching across the back. Look at these strikes, man. They're wild. They're absolutely wild. Elbow shot on the back of the head, right in between the shoulder blades, turning. Sean Savage round hangman elbow in the chin. Crow taking the fight to Sean Savage. Picks him up to his knees. Look at this. Goes to grab him. Sean Savage fights back with a punch in the face. Strong punch. Irish whip from Sean Savage. What's he got on the back elbow? And Crow goes down with force to the ground. Sean Savage drops down with a headbutt into the face of Crow. And Sean Savage lining them up for a second one and another headbutt onto the face of Crow. And Sean Savage now just taking the fight to him with a stamp on the face. He lifts Crow up to his feet. What's he got in mind? Going for a belly-to-belly. Crow bell chop! And a nice modified hip toss there. He's fighting back, man. Crow is taking this fight to Sean Savage again with these wild left-hand strikes, man. Oh, my God. Look at these boxing body blows. Crow with the Irish whip. What's he got in mind? Look at this big hip toss! Oh, my God. Lifting up the big guy and slams him down. Crow for the cover for the No Holds Barred Championship, but Sean Savage gets a foot on the bottom rope. Crow, oh my God! Just kicked him across the back! Can feel some anger and frustration boiling over in Crow, but this guy is just ruthless, man. This guy's ruthless. Runs in close like Savage to the outside, oh my God! Crow taking the fight to the No Holds Barred Champion here tonight at Legacy. Crow's going out after him, man. Crow's going out after him as he picks Sean Savage up to his feet. And look at this, grabbing Sean Savage by the head. What are you doing, Crow? What are you doing? Oh, my God. He's dragging him to the steel stairs. Oh, slams his face on the steel stairs. Sean Savage goes down. And now Crow going under the ring for a weapon. And Sean Savage desperately trying to get up to his feet. Oh, my God. A black bat. A blackjack right across the head. And another one. And Sean Savage is just taking these blows from this blackjack. Crow, oh, my God. Just vicious. Imagine what that does to your body, man. Imagine what that does to your body. Imagine how that feels and throws Sean Savage into the barrier. Look at these strike right hands from Crow. Taking the fight to Savage like no other man. And look at this. Savage don't even know where he is right now. He's just getting bludgeoned. And now Crow turning Savage around, grabbing him, dragging him by the head, throws him into that barrier. Crow, what are you doing, man? What are you doing? Irish whip. Oh, my God. Irish whip into the barrier. Oh, my God. Savage crumbles down, man. Savage crumbles down. I don't think he was expecting this from Crow, but you don't know Crow like I know him, Savage. This guy's a maniac. Crow going under the ring. What's he got now? He's got a kendo stick, and Savage trying to pull himself up on those ropes. Savage, oh my God, right in between the eyes with a kendo stick. Did you hear the sound that made? One, two, three, Crow, no. I thought he was going to become the no-holds-bar champion, but Savage kicks out. What's Crow doing now? He's got that kendo stick again, and he's just watching Savage trying to get up to his feet. Savage trying to get up. Oh my God, across the back of the head with a kendo stick. Oh my God. One, two, no holds bar champion, no. Savage kicks out. I mean, the guy's a resilient son of a bitch. We know that. But I mean, how many times can you kick out a kendo stick around the back of the head? Crow picking Sean Savage up to his feet. I mean, this is one-sided at this point. Savage was looking strong early on. Crow's got that kendo stick again. Oh my God, in the face, and Savage crumbles down to the corner in a seated position, and Crow is just hacking at him. Just hacking at him with a kendo stick for the cover. New champion, one, two, three. Savage kicks out. It's not enough, but I don't know how much more this guy can take. Oh my God. Crow is a vicious and violent and vindictive son of a bitch, man. And Crow grabbing Sean Savage by the head, and what's he got in mind now? Smash in the face onto that turnbuckle post. Punch to the abdomen. Punch to the abdomen again. And Savage switches out. Savage off the rope as he threw Crow into the corner and runs in. And look at this big clothesline. Another one, another one. Oh, you can tell Savage is desperately trying to fight back now. Someone lit a fire inside of him, and now he's got the kendo stick. Now he's got the kendo stick. And oh my God, across the back. Krog's back's gonna weld up after that, man, because that was a vicious shot, and Sean Savage is just stalking Crow, and Crow using that bottom rope to try and lift himself up. Crow, oh my God, takes a shot across the abdomen from Sean Savage, and now across the back of the head. Oh my God. These two just tearing each other apart tonight at Legacy. Belly to belly suplex onto that kendo stick. Oh my God. You want violence, Crow. You're going to get it from Sean Savage for the cover one, for the cover two. No holds barred champion retention. No! Crow kicks out. Crow kicks out. I told you Crow's a resilient son of a bitch. And now Sean Savage just mounting him and throwing these vicious strikes into him. Crow tries to cover his head, but Savage just stamps on the stomach. And again, imagine what it feels like to have your stomach stamped on by a guy the size of Sean Savage. But Crow butt forward out, ran at him, and Sean Savage back body dropped him and just kicked him right in between the shoulder blades, and Savage is just stamping on him. Savage is just stamping on him, lifting the head of Crow up, and oh my God, drives a knee through it. Imagine the whiplash of your neck and head and jaw. One, two, to retain the championship. Three, no, Crow kicks out. My God. My God, these guys tearing each other apart here tonight. And look at this, Sean Savage. Suplex slam and slams Crow down with force. Sean Savage looking it, hooking in another one and another suplex slam and slams him down onto that kendo stick. And Sean Savage knows he's in control. And this is when he's at his most dangerous, because Sean Savage is going under the ring. And what's he going to get? What's he going to get? Oh my God, he's got a table. Sean Savage has got a freaking table here tonight. No holds barred championship on the line, and he's got that kendo stick. Crow's trying to get up, and he just whacks him right across the back of the head, and Crow goes down. Crow turning over. He's desperately trying to crawl. He's desperately trying to get up to his feet, but he's feeling the effect of those kendo stick shots, man. The suplex slams. And Sean Savage, big strike to the abdomen, big knee in the abdomen of Crow, and stamping on his chest, and another one, and Crow goes down. He's still trying to get up, trying to grab that bottom rope. But look at Savage, just watching Crow. He sees a weakness, man. He sees an opportunity. He's like a predator who smells blood. He's like a predator who's got prey with an injured leg, and he's just hunting him down, just scoping him out. Crow's in a bad way. Savage just choked him across that top rope, and now he's picking him up to his feet. And what Sean Savage got in mind as he grabs the head of Crow, and he's dragging him towards that table, and he slams him into that table. Oh my God, Crow's in a bad position. Crow is in a bad position. Savage runs in, and Crow moves out the way, and Savage goes cascading through the table that he set up. And now Crow sees an opportunity, because Savage is trying to climb his way up, and he's holding against the ropes, and Savage, Crow runs in with that kendo stick across the the abdomen. More kendo stick shots from Crow. More kendo stick shots from Crow. Man, how many shots? How many shots can a human body take? And this is Crow's opportunity as he picks Savage up and he's just stamping him. Look at this forearm smash from Crow to the side of the head of Sean Savage. And Crow is taunting Savage up and Savage doesn't know where he is. He doesn't know what time of day it is. He doesn't know what day of the week it is. Oh, the Asylum Slam taking a Sean Savage to the Asylum. Crow, Luno, Host Bar Champion, 1, 2, putting him away. 3, Savage kicks out the Asylum Slam. He kicks out the signature maneuver and Crow can't believe it. Crow can't believe it and he's just looking at Sean Savage and I sense something twisted going on in the mind of this guy. What is Crow doing? Oh, he's going to go for the birdcage! He's going to go for the birdcage and he's got that signature submission locked in on Sean Savage and there ain't nowhere to go. You're in the center of the ring, son. You're in the center of the freaking ring, son. And Crow applying that birdcage submission. What can Sean Savage do in this position, man? What can you do? Look at the way that's stretching the ligaments of every upper body freaking ligament in your freaking body, man. I don't even know what to say because I can't imagine the pain of this hold. And Sean Savage is holding in there somehow. But Crow keeps putting torque on, keeps bending it back, keep putting leverage on it. Sean Savage rolls him over. Sean Savage punch to the face, punch to the face, punch to the face. He's fighting back desperately. And Crow shoot from that punch. Crow! Sean Savage runs straight through him like a freight train. Sean Savage picking Crow up to his feet. Look at this. Grabs him, throws him over. Two hands around the neck, just launching him, and Sean Savage is back in the game. Crow unconscious on the floor, man. He was going to go for the birdcage. I think he thought he could have Sean Savage, but now Sean Savage has got a freaking chair. And he gets into the ring, and you can see Crow is desperately trying to get up to his feet, and Sean Savage is just looking at him. He's just watching the broken Crow get up to his feet. Savage right in between the face with a steel chair. And what the, I told you, man, Crow getting back up, man, he's still getting up. This is what I'm talking about. Look at Savage, just look at him, chair shot between the eyes again. Oh my god, and he's getting up. What the hell, how can you take two chair shots and Crow still getting up to his feet? Look at Savage, man. Oh my god, a third one. And Crow split his head open, man. He's still getting up to his feet. He's still getting up to his feet. Look at him just looking at Sean Savage, man. I got fucking hairs on my arm standing up, man. How can he do that? Look at him. He's untouched. He's unmoved. He just got his head split open with 3 freaking chair shots. And Savage looks like he's seen a freaking ghost. 4th chair shot. Crow blocks it. Throws the chair away. What you gonna do, Savage? Oh, Crow grabs him from behind. Knee in the back. Knee in the back. Knee in the back. Look, there's all reverse DDT onto the chair. Oh, my God. And now Crow taunting Sean Savage up. This could be all she wrote. This could be all she wrote. Knife edge trap from Crow. Chopped to the face by Crow. Crow off the ropes. Oh, massive chop in between the eyes. And Savage goes down. And now Crow is taunting Savage up. Savage, what you gonna do against the guy who doesn't even go down for 4 freaking chair shots? Oh, impalement. It's over. New no holds bar champion. Oh no, here comes Skinner. Here comes Skinner. Crow just punches Skinner off like a bad conversation. Get out of here. Oh, here comes Static. Static with an elbow drop. He ain't gonna let Skinner get involved in this No Holds Barred Championship match. And Static, he's not booked on the show, but he ain't letting Bronx Bunny get involved. And he drags Skinner away. Look at this. Drags Skinner, throws him over the barrier. Here comes Bruiser now. These guys are gonna get freaking involved. You guys aren't even booked tonight. Bruiser just shouting at Crow, and look at Crow looking at Bruiser, goes for him, and Bruiser just drops off the apron like a little pansy, like a little pussy, and he's just staring, eyes staring, daggers at Crow. And what the hell, why is the crowd cheering? Oh my god, look, here he comes through the crowd. Oh, here comes Insane. What the hell? Oh my god, just dove through the gap in the turnbuckle and did a tornado DDT. This guy is insane. And Insano grabs Bruiser and grabs him around the back of the head, and now he's dragging Bruiser away. Look at this. And Insano throws him into the crowd. Oh no, for the cover, for the cover. Savage 2 for the cover. 3. Crow gets a shoulder up. It's not enough. Not the same fate that we saw at No Turning Back against Dr. Khan. Impalement. Oh, Savage with an elbow on that wound, and another one, and a third one right where that blood is pouring out. Oh no, Savage puts him in a mega bomb. Mega bomb! Oh my god, we've not seen that since before he went on hiatus. And Crow's still alive. He's still crawling, and Savage just stalking him. Crow battered and bruised from that mega bomb, and he's crawled himself up into the corner, and he doesn't know where he is, man. Oh no, oh no, he's in position. Savage, steamroller bulldozer into the face of Crow! Straight after a freaking mega bomb for the cover. 1, 2, 3 Savage retains the No Holds Barred Championship here tonight at Legacy. I don't believe it, man. Wow. Big match there, ladies and gentlemen. Big match. There's a replay of that steamroll of a bulldozer straight after a mega bomb. You know, Crow was already busted. 3 vicious elbow shots on his forehead where he was bleeding when he was trying to go for an impalement. Straight into a mega bomb, straight into a steamroller bulldozer, and that was enough to put Crow away here tonight at Legacy. And Sean Savage retains again with a solid title defense. You know, you can't take anything away from Crow. These guys beat the crap out of each other tonight. These guys went out there and they took each other to the limit. But tonight, this guy right here was the better man. I mean, you can argue that Bronx Bunny got involved. You can argue what you want, but it's a no-holds-barred match. You have to account for every single variable, every single factor. And at the end of the day, the guy that leaves with the belt is the victor. And that guy is this guy right here. Sean Savage retains the title again. Say what you want about Sean Savage. He's proven to be an incredible no-holds-barred champion. Ladies and gentlemen, up next, we will have Treble versus Riley Robin for the Ceremonial Championship. Here's a video package.
Haunted.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get this show on the road. This is Riley Robin making her way down to the ring, and I think that video package told us everything we need to know about this match. This is a blood feud that has raged since XWF Shockwave 46, where we crowned our first ever ceremonial champion. We had a gauntlet match, and this girl right here, Riley Robin, I think people overlook this fact that she eliminated Wicker and Athena in the same match. That's unheard of. And she believed the match had finished. She believed the match had finished, and she was literally about to be handed the ceremonial championship. And that's where Treble showed up, and Treble wasn't even signed to XWF. But it was an open invitation gauntlet. So she came out, she took Riley Robin, powerbombed her onto the freaking apron, Troublemakered her, pinned her, at which point the owner had no choice to give her a contract, and she had won the ceremonial championship. And Treble has, you know, she's proven absolutely dominant since then. Since then. And she was so close to becoming the women's champion because she cashed in her ceremonial championship. She had 10 defends on it. She cashed it in at boiling point, at which point Riley Robin made her return because she had been out injured ever since XWF Shockwave 46. And Riley Robin came out and cost Treble her world women's championship. And Treble and Riley have been butting heads ever since then. They've been attacking each other. This is a blood feud. And we hadn't managed to crown a ceremonial champion since Treble lost the belt at Boiling Point. So, Tommy T. Thomas did another open invitational gauntlet for the ceremonial championship. And Treble won, and then Riley Robin came out at the last minute, and they fought. And the belt was undecided because it was a double countout. At which point, Tommy T. Thomas said, right, we're going to end this. We're going to end this at Legacy. Let's create a legacy for the ceremonial champion. Let's create a new champion. And it'll either be Treble again, or it will be Riley Robin as the new ceremonial champion. And that belt is being held up right now. And these two look ready, man. These two look ready. Treble Robin spears Riley Robin. Oh my gosh, straight off the bat. Straight off the bat, and this is just Treble. You can feel the anger boiling in every single vein, in every single artery. Her blood is literally boiling, boiling up, man. And look at this Irish whip from Treble. What she got in mind? Treble, big hip toss on Riley Robin, launches her. Oh my god, if Riley Robin can't find a way to fight back, this could be quick. But she's fighting, man. Look at these strikes from Riley Robin. Treble blocks and a big punch in the face. You don't want to strike battle with Treble. Irish whip from Treble. Look at this, runs a big clothesline, taking Riley Robin off her feet. You can feel the hatred from these two, man. You can tell that these two want to beat each other like no other. Look at this, Treble trying to grab Riley. Riley pushes her away. Treble rolls through from that arm ringer. Oh, drop toe hold there from Treble. Riley holding the face. Treble runs in with a double axe handle. Modified. And look at this stamp on the chest. Textbook Treble. Textbook Treble and a kick in the face. Vicious. Vicious. Treble, elbow to the inside knee, wraps her legs around there, just punching the joint of the knee, just punching, punching, punching. This is the vicious, vindictive, malicious stuff that Treble does. This is what she does, big forearm smash. You don't want to strike battle. Look at this, oh, knife edge chop in return from Riley. She's trying to fight back, but Treble blocks it with a big strike. Knife edge chop, Riley blocks it, throwing these strikes. Riley's fighting her, man. Riley's having a fist fight. If you want one, she's going for it. Treble clubs her across the back, though. Treble one step ahead every time. Irish whip off the ropes, what Treble got in mind, jumps up, oh, Hurricane Rana! Nice Hurricane Rana from Riley Robin, this could be her opportunity. Treble trying to get up to her feet, Riley runs in and clotheslines her into the corner. This is a fight, this is a freaking fight, grabbing the ankles, hops her up, and slams her down. Riley Robin grabbing the head of Treble, picking her up to her feet, what's she got in mind, look at this, hooks the head. Oh, Riley head under the arm, oh, look at that beautiful suplex from Riley Robin. Do not doubt the wrestling background of this individual. Leg hook to the cover, that's one, and a kick out just after the one there by Treble. It's not enough, it's not enough, it's not enough. Treble trying to get up to her feet, looking winded from that suplex, and this is Riley Robin's opportunity, but Treble reverses the Irish rip, runs in, double knees to the chest cavity of Riley, and she trembles down to the floor. Treble stamping on the elbow joint, just vicious, just violent, just vindictive, like I said. When Treble's angry, you don't want to be on the wrong side of her. Russian leg sweep to the back of the head of Riley Robin, that's enough to give you concussion. Leg hook, that's one, that's two, that's three. No, it's a kick out by Riley Robin, it's not enough, she's still in the fight. But Treble is in control right now, and that's the worst part of a match. If you're Treble's opponent, if you're Riley Robin, you do not want Treble in control, because she's going to pick you apart like no other. Look at this back suplex, Riley Robin backflips out of it, runs in, school goal from Riley Robin for the ceremonial championship. One, 2, can she steal it? 3, Treble kicks out, it's not enough. Treble holding her head, that was danger close. But Riley's tired, man, look, she's tired. Them strikes are wearing her down. She managed a desperation schoolgirl, but she fights back with a toe kick. Riley runs in, left arm clothesline, nicely done, taking the hit off of Treble, and this is Riley Robbins' comeback. This is her chance to mount a comeback. Runs in, another left arm clothesline, taking Treble down, and Riley runs in and drops a double axe handle on the chest cavity. And Riley Robbins leg hook for the cover, that's 1. That's 2. No, Treble kicks out just before the 2. Look at Riley's face. He's thinking, what have I got to do to even get a 2 count on Treble? But we know how resilient Treble is. We know how good she is. Neck breaker there from Riley Robin. Nicely executed on the head and shoulder area of Treble. And Riley standing the attack. You know, she's getting the offensive, man. This is what she needs. Punch to the abdomen. Punch to the abdomen again. Riley grabs the legs of Treble. Throws him through the ropes. What's she doing? Grabs the head. Oh, look at his neck breaker. Rope hung style. Nicely done. From Riley Robin, she's got good offense on her, man. Leg hooked, Riley Robin for the ceremonial championship. 1, 2, can she put her away? No, a kick out just after the 2 by Treble. As I said moments ago, Treble has proved to be resilience. She's proved to be able to take a lot of punishment and keep coming back and wake up at a second's notice, just like that with the fireman's carry. Treble bludgeoning with an elbow shot to the back of the head. Front face lock goes for it again, but Riley fights out with a knee. Big strike to the face there. Big forearm, European uppercut there from Riley Robin. Anyone that said they thought Treble was going to destroy Riley Robin is wrong. She twists the arm. Oh, reversal into a drop toe hold there from Treble. And this is Treble's opportunity. Runs in. Luthes press on and punch in the face. One strong right hand from Treble as she picks Riley Robin up to her feet. Look at this forearm smash. This is the striking ability of Treble. You know, at our last CPV boiling point, we had our good friend Drake Stacy come onto commentary to commentate Treble versus Miss Fortune. And he said it himself. He said, Treble is one of the best strikers in OCW, and I'd say she's one of the best strikers in XWF. Look at these strikes from Riley Robin, boxing body punches, and a big punch to the face, and a clothesline takes her down. Riley Robin rocking Treble, leg hooks for the cover. That's 1. That's 2. That's 3. No, Treble kicks out. It's not enough. Intense match from these two so far. You can feel Riley Robin getting cocky, look, waving at Treble. You can feel the adrenaline and anger getting the better of her. Look at this for a gut wrench, but Treble rolls out. Such innovation. Treble under the arm. Oh my god, high angle back suplex right on the head and shoulder area. And that's a game changer. That's an absolute game changer. Knee to the abdomen. The striking ability, man. Double X handle on the back. Treble is dangerous. Look at this. Oh, leg stomper. Leg stomper. Wearing down every part of Riley Robin's body, and think of the pain and damage that is running through her head. And Riley scoops out the legs as Treble is trying to pick her up, and Treble tries to roll away, but Riley's stamping her, man. Riley's fighting back with all her might, goes for a spinning heel kick, but Treble scouts it and moves out the way. Riley trying to get up to her feet, she's tied. Treble off the rope with that modified neckbreaker style move. Signature Treble, leg hook for the cover. 1, 2, to championship, no! Treble so close to regaining her ceremonial championship as she puts it, but Riley Robbins showing great resiliency as she kicks out, and Treble just wearing it down with these strikes. Riley moves out the way, goes for a strike of her own. Treble blocks it, goes for a strike of her own. Riley dodges and a kick to the abdomen. Riley runs in up onto the shoulders, and another hurricane runner from Riley Robbins. Riley Robin getting fired up. You can feel her feeding off the fans' energy, and she runs in on a big forearm smash, jumping into the face of Treble, and she picks Treble up. Treble stunned, man. She's rocked. She's dazed, and look at this. Oh, pay dirt! Nice move. Nice move from Riley Robin. Is it nice enough to take the championship? That's 1, 2, new champion. 3, no! Treble kicks out. So resilient. You know, I feel like these two have got a fire burning in their soul that they're going to kick out of everything unless these guys kill each other, man. Riley trying to taunt Treble up, but Treble goes for a clothesline and a second one. Treble off the rope. Calf kick in the face of Riley Robin knocks her off her feet. Viciously done as Treble picks Riley up to her feet. Under the arm. German suplex on. Riley Robin backflipped over it. Lifts Treble up. Clothesline from Riley Robin. And another clothesline from Riley Robin. Treble goes for a clothesline. Riley under the arm. Big pop-up drop kick in the face of Treble and knocks her off her feet. And Riley's fired up, man. She's torn in Treble up. What's she gonna go for? Oh, she goes to grab her for a round robin, but feet arm drag there from Treble, and Treble head under the arm. Oh, here we go. Falcon arrow from Treble, the signature move. That could be it. That could be all she wrote. The leg is hooked from Treble. That's 1. That's 2 for the ceremonial championship. 3, Riley Robin kicks out. Look at Treble's face. Treble thought she had her for sure, but Riley Robin dug down deep, and what's Treble doing, man? Treble's lining her up, and Riley's trying to get to her feet. She doesn't know where she is. Treble, 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 spear! Oh my god! That's gotta be it. That's gotta be it. Leg hooked. One, two, three. Riley Robin kicks out. Oh my God. The resiliency from Riley Robin. You know, this is the biggest match of her career, and she's digging down deep, and now Tribble's taunting her for a treble maker, and if she hits this, this lights out. Riley Robin catches her with the clothesline. She scouted it, and another clothesline. Oh, under the arm of Tribble. Riley Robin, pop-up dropkick again, again, and Tribble rolls out the ring to safety, feeling that dropkick. Oh, Riley Robin off the rope. Riley Robin, oh, suicide dive. Oh my God, and Tribble went back first into that audience barrier, and you can see Riley's tired. You can see she's tired. But she's getting back in the ring. She's getting back in the ring. And look at this. Riley Robin torn into the fans. And the ref begins the count. And Riley just leaving Tribble out there to rot. She's just leaving Tribble to rot. And Tribble ain't moving, man. The force at which she hit that barrier, that was brutal. That was brutal. And the ref continues to count, man. The ref continues to count. And Tribble continues to not move. If Tribble gets counted out, Riley Robin will become the ceremonial champion. And imagine how much that would hurt Tribble to know that she was left to rot on the outside. How degrading! Tribble trying to get up, man, but that count's high. That's a 9 count, man. And Tribble trying to get up. Riley Robin, the scorn in her face. She just broke the count. She's gone back out for it. You could have won, Riley. You could have won. Oh, my God, no. She's going to powerbomb her on the apron. She's going to powerbomb her. She's going to give it back to her. No, Riley. Riley, Tribble's fighting back with 3 strong hands. And she kicks Riley down. No, Tribble. Oh, no. No, no, no. Powerbomb on the apron just like 46. Just like episode 46 of Shockwave. And Tribble torn into the fans, and now Tribble getting back in the ring. Riley, you had it, man. You had it. You could have let her count out. You had it. But the scorn on her face, she wanted Tribble to feel what she felt. She wanted Tribble to be ridden off like she was ridden off. And now Riley, that mistake has just cost her dearly because she got powerbombed on the freaking apron again. And Tribble just pacing around the ring and just watching that Riley Robin can't get up. And that's an 8 count. And Riley's trying so desperately. She's battered. She's bruised. Somehow she's getting to her feet. That's a 9 count. That's a 9 count. Riley's getting in the ring. Tribble's behind the ref. The ref moves. Tribble maker. Tribble from behind the ref. Riley didn't see her. 1, 2, 3. Tribble wins the ceremonial championship back. She wins the belt back. And Tribble looks pleased for herself. Riley Robin just made a mistake, man. I get it. She was emotionally driven. That she was 1 second away from becoming the ceremonial championship, but she let her emotions get on top of her. She wanted Tribble to feel what she felt. She wanted Tribble to be ridden off like Tribble wrote her off. But was it worth it? No, because she lost the match. She lost the ceremonial championship that she says was rightfully hers, and Tribble becomes the second ever XWF ceremonial champion. The woman that put that title on the map is back in possession of it, and look how pleased she is. Riley Robin's only new man. This is a mistake that will haunt her for a long time to come, I'm sure. But she let her emotions get in control. She let her emotions overtake her ability to win that match. And that hurts, man. It hurts me, and I'm sure it hurts the fans. But Tribble will be a champion just like she was. We got a video package. We're moving on. Thank you. This is it, ladies and gentlemen. You want to name a CPV legacy? There ain't no better legacy match than Reverend Al versus Mike Jacobs, two of the greatest all-round pound-for-pound wrestlers we have ever seen, we have ever witnessed. And they're going to face off tonight for the Internet Championship, a belt that has been called the Workers' Title, a belt that has put so many great names on the map. You want to add credibility to that championship. You put two of the greatest technicians in the ring. You give them the sub-main event headline slot. You put them out there, and they're going to work magic, ladies and gentlemen. They're going to work magic. Who's going to come out on top? I do not know, but I can tell you this much. We're in for a great match. We got two men who are the very best of their game, man. These guys are all-rounders, all freaking rounders. Write down on a piece of paper every single thing, every single element it takes to be one of the greatest pro wrestlers of all time. Do it, I freaking dare you, and put a column for each freaking category and tell me right now that Reverend Al wouldn't be in every single category. Tell me right now that Mike Jacobs would not be in every single damn category, and tell me that these two guys would not be high up in the freaking list of every single category. You can't tell me that that is not true, because it is true, fact undeniable. Mike the Viper Jacobs. He went undefeated for the whole of season one at CPVs right up until Absolution. There was nobody else on the roster that did that. And this guy right here, Reverend Al, the Internet Champion, and no one expected him to return at no turning back to XWF. No one expected Reverend Al to beat Jacob Drake for the Internet Championship. No one expected Reverend Al to have the reign with that championship that he has had. Arguably, I'm going to say it now, I don't care if you want to say Jacob Drake's one of the greatest Internet Champions of all time. I know I've said that before, and I mean it, and I agree with it, and I stand by it. But tell me right now that Reverend Al's reign with this championship has not been one of the best that we have ever seen with this championship. Somebody chuck the 10 defender up on screen, I want to see it. Look at this. Zebro, Luke Loins, Brendan X, Harry Mills, Hazard, Brendan X, Reverend, James Cougar. This guy has put the work in and had great matches every single time. And now he's going to have to fight arguably the hardest challenge since he has been the Internet Champion. Because he fights Mike Jacobs, and that belt goes on the line right there. Internet Championship. Arguably the highest profile match this belt has ever seen. And to see the Internet Championship being defended so late into a CPV makes me happy. Because I can tell you, once upon a time, this belt was only designed and planned to be defended on XWF Aftershock, which was our sideshow. That was the point of that belt. But the guys took that belt, they ran with it, and every single Internet Champion added credibility to that belt. And now it's important enough to be the sub-main event. Now it's important enough to be wrestled by Reverend Al, a legend from the XWA, a guy that's been around for so long. Now it's good enough to be defended by him and challenged by a guy that's held it before, Mike the Viper Jacobs. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm ready for this, man. I'm ready for this. Mike Jacobs made this personal when he hit Reverend Al with three belly-to-belly suplexes last show. I'm interested to see where this goes, and they're just looking at each other, man. They're just looking at each other. Reverend Al just staring into the eyes of Mike Jacobs. Mike Jacobs just staring into the eyes of Reverend Al, because they both know how good each other are. These guys have never wrestled, but they know the legacy that stands between these guys, and Reverend Al's just looking back, man. Eyes of stone, vision of stone. Mike Jacobs' resolve, strong. These guys ain't gonna back down. These guys ain't gonna back down, ladies and gentlemen. You can feel the electricity. You can feel the electricity. Here they go. Locking horns. Who's the stronger man? Who's the stronger man when it comes to a tie-up? Reverend Al slips behind with a waist lock. Has Mike Jacobs got a way out? Of course he has. Snap near. And he's got that chin-mounted lock on the floor. And he's just wearing down the body of Reverend Al. Has Reverend Al got away? Mike Jacobs with a strong fist across the chest to try and wear Reverend Al out, to stop him from getting up. But Reverend Al using his body weight, strength, leverage, hips him over with a arm drag style move. And look at this. Mike Jacobs uses a leg scissors to move Reverend Al down. Technical wrestling. Headlock, ground mounted headlock here from Reverend Al. These guys using the rule wrestling book, man. Using the wrestling book up to his feet. Side headlock from Mike Jacobs. What's he got in mind? Look at this. Oh, Mike Jacobs, hip toss on Reverend Al. And Reverend Al's been outdone by Mike Jacobs, man. Up to his feet. Little stare down, going to lock horns, but Mike Jacobs is reversed by Reverend Dow, and Reverend Dow reverses the European uppercut. Oh, Reverend Dow gets a foot up. Look at this. O'Connor roll for the one. No, Mike Jacobs pushes him off. He knew it. He saw it coming, and another little stare down from these guys. Look at this, Mike Jacobs goes to grab Al, but Al hits him with the toe kick in the abdomen. What's Reverend Al got in mind? He tries to grab him. Mike Jacobs punches him away, goes for a punch. Reverend Al blocks it with a toe kick. Grabbing the arm, Irish whip here from Reverend Al. Look at this, goes to grab him, but Mike Jacobs pulls the head and hits him with a club on the shoulder. Small package from Mike Jacobs. One step ahead of Reverend Al, that's one. That's two, and a kick out just before the two there by Reverend Al. Mike Jacobs seems to be in control here. Goes for a hip toss. Oh, Reverend Al, I speak too soon. Scoops him through with his innovative pin. One, two. Oh, it's not enough. It's still a kick out on two there. These guys pulling out every single page of the wrestling textbook here. Look at this backslide for Mike Jacobs to get the cover on Reverend Al. That's one. That's two. And Reverend Al kicks out. It's not enough. A little stare down from these two guys again. Oh, my God. You can feel the fire. These guys know how good each other are. These guys have got answers for each other's offense. Who's going to come out on top? I can't call this one, man. Forearm smash from Mike Jacobs. Look at this. Mike Jacobs is for a suplex. Get a freaking notepad ready, because not only is Reverend Al going to hit some suplexes tonight, Mike Jacobs can go toe-to-toe when it comes to suplexes. I swear to God, Mike Jacobs has got suplexes for days, just like Reverend Al. Irish whip from Mike Jacobs. What's he got in mind? Belly to belly, but Reverend Al fights out with an elbow to the face. Oh, belly to belly. No. they're fighting over these belly to bellies. Mike Jacobs pulls the arm down with this invert arm bar, wrenching on the arm of Reverend Al as he got a way out. Look at Reverend Al rolling. Reverend Al rolls through. They go to grab horns. They go to lock horns, but Reverend Al uses a front face lock and takes control. Forearm smash, Irish whip here from Reverend Al. What's he got in mind? Goes for a kick. Reversal. Mike Jacobs blocked it, but then Reverend Al span him out and hit him down with a wrestling gut wrench reverse takedown. And now Reverend Al for the cover. That's one. That's two. No, it's not even a two. Mike Jacobs remains in the game early on from these two, man. I think these two are going to take this as long as it can. Reverend Al, nice textbook wrestling shin breaker there. Work down the base of Mike Jacobs, and as the match goes on, that will take offense. That will take effect. Mike Jacobs trying to get up into the corner. Reverend Al goes to grab him, but Mike Jacobs switches him in with two strong right hands like bricks. Irish whip into the corner. Here goes Mike Jacobs going for a shoulder tackle, but Reverend Al moves out the way and a cross body in the corner. Like it. Very nice. Reverend Al smiling to the fans there because he knew he caught Mike Jacobs out for the cover. That's one. That's two. And a kick out just after the two there by Mike Jacobs. It's good. It's close, but it ain't no cigar. Mike Jacobs trying to get up to his feet. Reverend Al controlling the pace, controlling the action. Belly to belly suplex. No. Mike Jacobs with three strong fists there to block it. And now Mike Jacobs head on the Reverend Al's arm. Look at this. Big stalling suplex. And he slams Reverend Al with 10 tons of force, man. 10 tons of force. A big friggin' suplex. And now Mike Jacobs, belly to belly suplex. There we go. First one of the match. And it's Mike Jacobs who does it. The signature belly-to-belly suplex of Reverend Al. And Mike Jacobs does it to him. Oh, no. Here we go. A second one. Get the notepad ready. That's a second belly-to-belly suplex from Mike Jacobs. And he picks Reverend Al up to his feet. Oh, third one. No. Bell trap by Reverend Al. He ain't having it. Reverend Al, belly-to-belly suplex. Who's got the best belly-to-belly suplex? Who's got the freaking best one? Reverend Al picking Mike Jacobs up. I think he was looking tired, man. Two of those belly-to-belly suplexes. And another belly-to-belly suplex from Reverend Al. These guys are just going to throw freaking belly-to-bellies at each other all night, man. And I'm going to love it. Belly-to-belly. No. Mike Jacobs reverses it with a bell clap and a modified hip toss for the cover. That's one. That's two. And Reverend Al gets a shoulder up. Reverend Al gets a shoulder up, man. This is intense. Internet championship on the line. XWF Legacy. Strong forearm smash there from Mike Jacobs. And he's just wearing Reverend Al down with these clubs across the back while he's in the corner. And Mike Jacobs turns Reverend Al around. Puts him into the corner. And what's he doing here? Head on the arm. Onto the second rope. Big suplex off the second rope from Mike Jacobs. Think of what that does to your body. Think of the damage that does to your spinal column. One. Two. Three. It's not enough. Reverend Al gets a shoulder up. Reverend Al gets a shoulder up, ladies and gentlemen. These guys going at it. I don't know how much wear and tear these guys can take. Nice reversal there from Mike Jacobs, from Reverend Al. And then Mike Jacobs reverses Reverend Al's scoop slam. And then Mike Jacobs goes for a scoop slam. And Reverend Al reverses that. Reverend Al goes for an Irish whip. And Mike Jacobs reverses it, slaps the arm, kicks him down, and clotheslines him. Mike Jacobs one step ahead of Reverend Al now. That's one. That's two. That's three. No, kick out on 2.5 there by Reverend Al. Mike Jacobs now in the driver's seat. He's got control of the steering wheel. He's got control of the gears. He's got control of the gas pedal. And he's taking these strikes to Reverend Dow. He's wearing him down. And this is where Mike Jacobs likes to be, in a knee to the face. Getting violent, getting vicious. And he's taunting to the fans. And Reverend Dow starting to feel this vicious, relentless assault of Mike Jacobs. And look at Mike Jacobs' textbook scoop slam. Slamming down Reverend Dow. And he stamps on the shoulder, wearing down the body. And here we go with a grounded reverse bear hug, squeezing the air out of Reverend Dow like a toothpaste out of a freaking toothpaste tube. And now Mike Jacobs stamps on the back. Oh, a camel clutch. And Mike Jacobs using his body weight to wear down and stretch the abdominal muscles of Reverend Dow. And Reverend Dow's trying to reach for the ropes with his foot. He knows where he is in the ring, and he knows he's so close to that bottom rope, but he can't quite reach it. And Mike Jacobs applying the pressure, using the body weight, using that low squat position to really wrench back on the jaw, to really wrench every abdominal muscle and ligament that Reverend Dow's got. And Mike Jacobs ain't holding up. He ain't letting up on this man. He's applying it with force, and Reverend Dow's in a bad way. Reverend Dow slips under, pulls out the legs. That's what Reverend Dow needed. He was waiting for that opportunity, and now he gets him. German suplex from Reverend Dow. That's the game changer. That's the G-A-M-E changer. That's what you need. And Reverend Dow, exploder suplex. Get the notepad out. Get the notepad and start writing those freaking ticks. Oh, hip toss from Reverend Dow. Mountain that comeback. You can feel the fans getting behind him. You can feel the fire. The belly to belly suplex from Reverend Dow. This is what he needed, because that camel clutch was wearing him down, man. And that's going to take effect to this match. Goes on clothesline. No, Mike Jacobs reverses it, and he kicks him. Twists the arm, kicks him. Irish whip from Mike Jacobs. Mike Jacobs goes for a kick. Reverend Dow blocks it. Knee to the knee. Elbow to the knee. Clothesline from Reverend Dow. And another one. Mike Jacobs up to his feet. Third clothesline. Just chewing clotheslines like freaking candy. And here he comes in, runs in, shoulder block from Reverend Dow. Here we go, belly to belly suplex. Yes, Reverend Dow is getting back in control. Clothesline, and he gets cut down. Mike Jacobs just cuts the momentum like instant. 1, 2, 3. How do you stop this guy, man? Reverend Dow dug down so deep. He got the crowd behind him. He got the energy flowing, and he started mounting the comeback that he needed. But Mike Jacobs got back in the game. A net breaker reversed out the suplex. These guys can reverse everything. These guys have got an answer for everything. Forearm smash from Mike Jacobs. Runs in, clothesline from Mike Jacobs. Reverend Dow up to his feet. Oh, Thor Nelson face buster from Mike Jacobs. Classic vintage Mike Jacobs. And now he's taunting Reverend Dow up. And Reverend Dow, you got to find a way out of this, man, because this ain't looking good for you. Oh no, extreme German suplex on the head and shoulder area, and that could be it, ladies and gentlemen. Mike Jacobs torn into the fans because he knows he's in control, and Reverend Dow ain't moving, man. That extreme German suplex has put many people away, and Mike Jacobs turns him over. He's gonna go for a sharpshooter, but Reverend Dow woke up and he kicked him away with that leg press move with them strong quads, and he's gonna go for a belly to belly suplex, but Mike Jacobs is dead weighting him. It's not enough. He saw it coming. He scouted it. Reverend Dow gets clotheslined off his feet, and Mike Jacobs is wearing Reverend Dow down. He's wearing him down, and he's countering everything that he's got, and Mike Jacobs knows Reverend Dow's moves. He knows him. Modified suplex from Mike Jacobs. Reverend Dow's in a bad way, man. 1, 2, 3. Reverend Dow kicks out on 2.9. And Mike Jacobs looks like he can't believe it, but he's got to stay on the attack, and that's what he's doing, because Mike Jacobs like a blood shark that smells blood. One droplet in the water, and that's all he needs. High angle back suplex. Crushing Mike Jacobs. Crushing Reverend Dow into the mat, and Mike Jacobs just picking him apart with stomps, man. Grabbing the head and picking Reverend Dow up. Reverend Dow back body drop. He's fighting back. He's digging down into the depths of his soul, and he's fighting back after all this punishment. But Mike Jacobs blocks it and throws a punch. Reverend Dow blocks a punch, throws a punch of his own. These guys just exchanging fists, exchanging punches. Mike Jacobs blocks Reverend Dow, wildly swinging a European uppercut, and he takes Mike Jacobs off his feet. This is what Reverend Dow needs. European uppercut again. And he takes Mike Jacobs off his feet again. And Mike Jacobs lifted up to his feet. And Reverend Dow just wearing down. You can tell he's tired. You can tell he's low on energy. But he's just throwing these strikes. He's digging down to the depths of his soul and everything he's got. And he's got the atonement lock. He's got the atonement lock locked in. The Achilles heel lock. And he's holding it in. And Mike Jacobs ain't near the ropes, man. He's slap bang in center in the ring. Just as Reverend Dow anticipated it. He knew his ring positioning. He knew what he had to do. And Mike Jacobs is reaching for that rope and he's trying to crawl for it. And the referee is saying, do you submit? Do you give up? And Mike Jacobs will not give up. I can tell you now, Mike Jacobs would rather fucking die than give up in this position. He would rather die than tap out at CPV. But he's reaching for those ropes and there's only so much body. There's only so much pain a human body can take. There's only so much pain a human nervous system can take. There's only so much pain any person can take. Mike Jacobs is going to have to tap. He's going to have to submit because there is no way out right now. Mike Jacobs, look at this, using his body weight to turn him over. Punch to the face, punch to the face, punch to the face. Reverend Al releases the hold and Mike Jacobs holding his leg. He's going to feel that. He's going to feel that for the rest of the match. Clothesline from Mike Jacobs. Clothesline from Reverend Al back into the game. Oh, third clothesline. Oh my God, taking the head. And Reverend Al sees an opportunity. Mike Jacobs in the corner. Shoulder block. This is it. This is it. Belly to belly suplex from Reverend Al. And he's throwing Mike Jacobs up. He's taunting Mike Jacobs up, and Mike Jacobs doesn't know what time of day it is. Oh, under the arm, back suplex from Reverend Al, and he holds on. The cardiovascular power, German suplex, get the notepad ready. Our last count of these suplexes, our last count of them, turns him around. Oh, vertical suplex from Reverend Al. You want to be the best, you got to beat the best. He said him right now. Reverend Al's in control, and he's going up to the top rope for a leap of faith, a leap of faith at Legacy for the championship. No, knees up from Mike Jacobs, knees up. He saw it coming. He saw it coming, and Reverend Al's feeling that, man. He's trying to get up to his feet. Mike Jacobs under the arm. Oh, my God. Back suplex from Mike Jacobs, and he's staying, and he's holding on. He's going to do it again. He's going to do it again. German suplex. He's playing Reverend Al at his own freaking game. He's doing Reverend Al's own combination on him. Mike Jacobs suplex on Reverend Al. Oh, my God. Think of the suplexes. Think of the damage that is running through these bodies. Think of how much wear and tear on the body of these men they're going to have to endure after this match. And Mike Jacobs just looking at Reverend Al with a sick look in his eyes. And what's Mike Jacobs doing, man? What's he doing? He's going up top. Mike Jacobs, what the hell are you doing? What the hell? What the hell? Mike Jacobs, leap of faith. Oh, Reverend Al moves out the way. Reverend Al moves out the way. Mike Jacobs, high risk. It didn't pay off. German suplex from Reverend Al. And he's holding on. And he turns. Reverend Al turns him around in a big lariat. Oh, my God. Mike Jacobs span out of it. One, two, to retain the championship. Three, no. Mike Jacobs kicks out. Look at Reverend Al's face. He can't believe it. I can't even process that. Mike Jacobs tried a leap of faith. He wanted to do what Reverend Al could do, but better. He used his own back suplex. He used his own German suplex. He used his own vertical suplex against him. He went for a leap of faith, but Mike Jacobs missed because Reverend Al saw it coming at the last minute. He moved out the way, and now Reverend Al, this is what he needs. He's just throwing these wild strikes, just throwing jabs, every single last bit of cardiovascular energy that this man can exhibit from his body. Every single oxygen particle that is flowing through his red blood cells. He's digging down deep, and he's just throwing these strikes, man. He ain't even grappling anymore. He's just fighting because that's all he's got left in the tank with a European uppercut. This is your moment, Reverend Al. But the punch is blocked by Mike Jacobs. And Mike Jacobs goes for a punch. Reverend Al blocks it. These guys are slugging, man. Mike Jacobs with a European uppercut. Reverend Al still on his feet. Irish whip, but Reverend Al reverses it. Mike Jacobs holds onto the rope. Reverend Al goes to punch, and Mike Jacobs blocks it. Strikes him. Gets back in the ring. What's Reverend Al got in mind? No, Mike Jacobs whips him into the corner. Big strike there from Mike Jacobs. Big strike there from Mike Jacobs. And Reverend Al's looking like a strong wind could blow him down. And Reverend Al is lifted up onto the shoulder of Mike Jacobs. And Mike Jacobs puts him onto the top rope, and he goes up. Arm drag. No, Reverend Al holds on. Strike to the head. Headbutt from Reverend Al. Headbutt from Reverend Al. Oh, whoa! Flip sent on from the second rope. I don't believe it. Reverend Al digging down every move he's got. Every repertoire move. One, to retain the championship. Two, to retain the championship. No, Mike Jacobs kicks out. Oh, my God. I can't believe it. These two taking each other to hell. These guys taking each other to the very depths of their soul with every last fiber of their being. What have they got to do to end this match? What has one of these guys got to do to put the other guy away into the corner? Reverend Al with these strong strikes on Mike Jacobs, and now he's moving Mike Jacobs onto his shoulder. What's he doing? Putting Mike Jacobs onto the top rope. Al, what are you doing, man? What are you doing? Swapping the legs out onto the top rope. What's he doing? What's he doing? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Belly to belly suplex off the top. Oh, my God. Mike Jacobs comes crashing down with force. He comes crashing down with force. And Reverend Al sees an opportunity. He sees an opportunity. He's going to the top rope. Reverend Al to retain the championship. If he lands this, it could be all she wrote. Leap of faith onto Mike Jacobs. Belly to belly off the top. Then a leap of faith. That's got to be it. That's one. That's two. That's three. Reverend Al retains the XWF Internet Championship in one of the most brutal matches, man. Brutal in the way that their bodies have been worn, their bodies have been torn. No weapons, no mad flips, just wrestling, man, just wrestling. And these two went out there and they put it all on the line. But Reverend Al solidifies this reign with a ninth title defense. A ninth title defense over one of the greatest all-for-all, pound-for-pound wrestlers, Mike the Viper Jacobs. And I think these guys are going to have respect for each other, whatever happens after the fallout of this match. But for now, Reverend Al solidifies himself as an XWF legend. Solidifies himself as an XWA legend. He has still got it. He has still got it. Well done, Reverend Al. And we're going to move on, ladies and gentlemen, to our main event. Here is a video package.
Tell me where to go, tell me what to do, I'll be right there for you. Tell me what to say, no matter if it's true, I'll say it all for you.
I used to be the type of kid that would always think the sky is falling. Why am I so differently wired? Am I a Martian? What kind of twisted experiment am I involved in? Cause I don't belong in this world. That's why I'm scoffing at authority, defiant often, flying off to handle it, my mom, no dad. So I am non-compliant at home. At school, I'm just shying awkward. And I don't need no goddamn psychologist trying to diagnose why I have all these underlying problems, thinking he can try and solve them. I'm outside chalking up drawings on the sidewalk and in the front drive talking to myself. Either that or inside hiding off in the corner somewhere quiet, trying not to be noticed cause I'm crying and sobbing. I had a bad day at school so I ain't talking. Some cocksucker shoved me into a fucking lockup cause he said that I eyeballed him. This is my legacy, legacy. Would always think the sky is falling. Why am I so differently wired? Am I noggin? Cause sporadic as my thoughts come, it's mind-boggling. Cause I obsess on everything in my mind. Small shit bothers me, but not my father. He said sayonara and split, but I don't give a shit. I'm fine long as there's batteries in my Walkman. Nothing's the matter with me. Shit, look on the bright side. At least I ain't walking. I bike ride through the neighborhood of my apartment complex on a 10-speed, which I've acquired parts that I find in the garbage. A frame, then put tires on it, headphones on it, straight ahead of kids, try and start shit. But if this is all there is for me, life offers, why bother even trying to put up a fight? It's nonsense, but I think a light bulb just lit up in my conscience. What about them rhymes I've been jotting that kinda giving me confidence instead of trying to escape through my comics? Why don't I just blast a little something like Onyx to put me in the mood to wanna fight and write songs that say what I wanna say to that kid that said that I eyeballed him? Grab hold of my balls like that's right, fight's on, bitch. Who would've knew from the moment I turned the mic on that I could be iconic in my conquest? It's worth a fight dog from a tribe conquest.
This is my legacy.
Would always think the sky is falling. Now I think the fact that I'm differently wired is awesome. Cause if I wasn't, I wouldn't be able to work words like this and connect lines like crosswords and use my enemy's words as strength to try and draw from and get inspired off from. Cause all my life I was told and taught I am not shit by you whack fucking giant sacks of lying dog shit. Now you shut up, bitch, I am talking. Thought I was full of horseshit and now you fucking worship the ground on which I am walking. Me against the world, so what? I'm Brian Dawkins versus the whole 0-16 Lions offense. So bring on the Giants, Falcons, and Miami Dolphins. It's the body bag game, bitch, I'm supplying coffins. Cause you dick spot kiss, bunch of Brian ball dingers. You gon' diabolica, I've been diabolical with this dialogue since 99 Rockets. You don't respect the legacy I leave behind, y'all can suck a dick. this is my legacy.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is it. This is the main event of our XWF CPV Legacy. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for sticking with us. This is the big one. The XWF World Heavyweight Championship goes on the line. And this is the challenger right here. A legend, an XWA legend, an XWF legend. In my opinion, one of the greatest of all time. One of the most dominant of all time. His name is the Lethal Litigator. His name is Lord Lore. And if you haven't seen much Lord Lore, I urge you to go back at some point and watch the pure domination, the pure destructive path that this guy leaves behind him, because this guy is a brute force powerhouse that will decimate anyone. I swear down, this guy is somewhat unstoppable at times, man. This guy can soak up a fence like you've never seen. This guy can deliver a fence like you have never seen. This guy is a specimen of humanity in his strength, in his power, in his resiliency, in his everything. I got no more words for this guy. Lord Lore is one of the greatest of all time, and Lord Lore will go down in history as one of the greatest of all time. And tonight he challenges Damage for the XWF World Heavyweight Championship, a guy that he gave the first shot to. Lord Lore brought Damage in when Damage was just an indie guy. Lord Lore brought him into XWA in 2006 2007, and gave him an opportunity, gave him a rocket, a jetpack on his back that would give him a career that has led to this point where he would become a world champion. And Lord Lore says that him and Tommy T. Thomas created a monster when they started this guy's career, and it's their duty to put him down. But this guy is Damage, and do not underestimate Damage. Look at Damage. Look at him. Look at his career in XWF. He's a one-time no-holds-barred champion. He's a one-time tag team champion. And he's the current XWF World Heavyweight Champion. Look at his defenses. Look at his matches since we came back from hiatus. Damage is the most consistent guy on the freaking roster. I swear to God, that's true. Damage is consistent. He has beaten guys left, right, and center. He has defended that title whenever he has had to defend that title. Anyone who's challenged him, he has taken that chat. He has taken that match, and he has defended that title. But tonight, he's got to fight Lord Lore. And this is Legacy. This is Legacy, because if Damage could beat Lord Lore, what would it do for his legacy? And if Lord Lore can beat Damage, like Tommy T. Thomas said, it would give Lord Lore and Tommy T. Thomas a legacy that they can end on. That they saved XWF, that the XWF they once tried to destroy with their bare hands. The challenger, Lord Lore, looking at Damage, looking at the guy that he once created, looking at the monster that his actions led to, Damage holding his World Heavyweight Championship, and you can't say that you don't see concern in the eyes of this guy. He knows how good Lord Lore is. He knows how destructive Lord Lore is. He's seen it firsthand over and over again when he was part of the corporate world order, and Lord Lore is his mentor. Lord Lore took Damage and Nightmare under his wing, and look at their careers. Because of Tommy T. Thomas, because of Lord Lore, they gave them their starts. Nightmare's a one-time World Heavyweight Champion, a one-time Tag Team Champion. Damage is the same, and a no-holds-barred champion. Oh my God, Swift Justice, what the hell? As soon as the bell rang, Damage wiped out. Damage wiped out, this is it, it's over. 1, 2, new champion, 3, Damage kicks out of Swift Justice at 2.99999999999 infinite. But what a start, man. What a start. Lord Lore, Swift Justice, and Damage off the bat. Damage doesn't even know where he is. Look at Lord Lore turning around. Lord Lore, European uppercut of Damage goes down with force. And now Lord Lore just stalking Damage. Damage trying to get up to his feet, man. He doesn't even know what there. The weak at his knee to the face. Big clothesline there from Lord Lore. Oh my God. Damage doesn't even know where he is, man. That's 1. That's 2. Could it be over? That's 3. Damage kicks out on 2.99999999 recurring. so close, man. And this is where Lord Lore becomes so dangerous, because he smells a drop of blood in the water, and he's like a freaking megalodon. He's just taking the fight to you, and if you can't find a way out of this, he is going to punish you like nothing you have ever been punished before. Damage trying to fight back. Rosalind goes, and oh my god, Lord Lore drops him onto the top rope with a freaking guillotine, and just stomps on his head, and stomps on his head again, picking Damage apart. This is the power of Lord Lore. These massive right hands like freaking sledgehammers in your face, man. Look at them. Oh my god. Oh my god. Damage, man. Clothesline. 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 Lord Lore. The power drags him out by his arm and clotheslines him again, man. Damage's body going through the freaking ringer right now. Going through the freaking ringer for the cover. That's one. That's two. That's three. And Damage gets out again somehow. You know, the World Heavyweight Championship on the line. If you're a champion, you are going to dig down to the depths of your soul, but how much punishment can you take from a guy like Lord Lore? How much punishment? He's trying to grab him for a scoop slam, and Damage is fighting back. Forearm smash to the face of Lord Lore, and again, throwing everything he's got, but Lord Lore grabs him and kicks him in the abdomen. This is bad for Damage. Damage using speed and guile to get behind Lord Lore, kicking him. More forearm smashes, front face lock, knee in the face. Damage mounting the comeback now. This is what the world champion needs. He's got to keep fighting. Throw everything he's got. Goes for an enziguri, but Lord Lore moves out the way. Punch from Lord Lore. Punch from Lord Lore. Damage, man. He's barely standing. Punch. He goes down. Oh, my God. The power that is Lord Lore, man. One. Two. And Damage kicks out just after the two. He's still in the game. He's still fighting. There's a reason that Damage is the world heavyweight champion. There's a reason that he has held that belt for so long. There is a reason that he has defended this title so many times. But could this be his last ever defense? Because Lord Lore is taking the fight, and he just rolls him through with an arm ringer. And Lord Lore, oh my god, just kicked Damage in the back of the head, and he fucking fell flying, man. Jesus Christ. Lord Lore picking Damage up to his feet. Big right hand, man. These right hands, look at them. My god. Damage doesn't know where he is. Irish whip from Lord Lore. What's he got in mind? Oh, Damage fireman carry. He's fighting back. Somehow, Damage is fighting against the powerhouse. That is Lord Lore. Against the machine. That is Lord Lore. And Damage is throwing some strikes. And now Irish whip into the corner. What's he got in mind? Damage runs in. Goes for a body splash. Lord Lore moves out the way. The speed of this guy runs in. Oh my god. Slams him down with his arm. Look at this. Damage on his. Oh my god. Damage trying to get up. Lord Lore big booted him through the fucking skull, man. One. Two. 3-0, just kick out on 2.5 there by Damage, digging down to the darkest depths of his freaking soul to kick out, because Lord Lore is taking Damage to the hell, man. Look at his chokeslam, no Damage, oh my god, using a pay dirt style move there, jumping STO reverse, and he's fighting back, stamping on the chest of Lord Lore. That could be the turning point that Damage needs to get in control. Like I said, if you let Lord Lore dominate a match, it ain't gonna last long, man. Damage with a super kick in the abdomen and a step up in Zaguri. Lord Lore crumbles down, and this is the best chance Damage has got all match. This is the best chance he's got. Face front face lock and knee in the face. Damage grabs the leg and cuts down those tree trunk like thighs with a dragon screw pull through, man. That's what Damage needs, and he grabs Lord Lore, moves him away from the ropes, and this is where Damage is gonna start picking apart the corpse. Look at these stamping on the faces, man. Stamping on the faces. This is exactly what he needs, and now Damage mounts Lord Lore and just starts throwing these fists. Lord Lore blocking it, but Damage stamps on the chest cavity. And Damage starting to just use these strikes, man, to wear down Lord Lore. This is what he needs. Picks Lord Lore up. Lord Lore grabs the arm, turns the arm around. Look at this. Slams the arm on his shoulder. Oh my god, the power of Lord Lore. Goes to grab Damage, but Damage is fighting back. Trying everything he's got. Scoop slam for Damage. Lord Lore. Chest, knee in the chest. Runs in for that running knee. Damage moves out of the way. Super kick in the back of the head. This is Damage's advantage, man. He's got to use his speed. He's got to use the spunk that he's got. Because Lord Lore's strong. He's powerful. But Damage has that speed advantage, and he's got to use that in every way he can. Every single way. Strikes in the corner here from Damage. Taking a fight, jumps up, knees Lord Lore in the face, draws him out. Big clothesline from Damage, taking the man down, taking the legal litigator down. And what's Damage doing? He's going to the apron. Lord Lore up to his feet. Here comes Damage. Springboard clothesline cuts Lord Lore down to size massively. Damage using his advantage. One, two, and a kick out on two there by Lord Lore. This is what Damage has got to use, man. He's got to use everything in his repertoire. He's got to use everything in his arsenal. He's got to use everything in his playbook if he's going to have a chance of beating Lord Lore tonight. Big forearm smash there from Damage, and another one. Lord Lore rocks from that, man. But Lord Lore blocks it and toe kicks Damage in the abdomen. Lord Lore goes for a punch. Damage speedily moving out the way and follows up with three strong forearms. Irish whip from Damage. What's he got in mind here? Goes for a clothesline. Lord Lore ducks under it. Grabs Damage. Oh my god! Sledgehammer-like punch. Damage rolls to the apron to try and recover, trying to pull himself up on the ropes. I mean, Damage throws all that assault at Lord Lore, and it doesn't do much. Damage jumps through with the sunset flip through the ropes, holding the arms. One, holding the hands. Two, he's going to try and sneak it out, but Lord Lore kicks out on the two. It's not enough. Lord Lore get him up to his feet. Damage goes for another super kick, but Lord Lore moves out the way, grabs damage. Oh, look at the power of Lord Lore. Look at the power. Oh my god, just launches him. Just freaking launches him. And what scares me is that everything damage has done against Lord Lore now. Everything he's done in this match so far, and Lord Lore looks fresh as the day he fucking woke up. Oh my god. Another suplex slam, just launching damage like he weighs freaking nothing. And look at the power of Lord Lore. Damage. Oh, fly back off. Spine buster. Oh my god. The power. One. Two. Gonna put him away. Three. No, damage kicks out. It's not enough. It's not enough. It's not enough. It's not enough. My god, that spine buster, man. The power of Lord Lore. It's destructive, man. It's destructive. Front face lock elbow shot on the back of the head, just bludgeoning the neck of damage. And another one. The sharp point of Lord Lore's elbow, man. Irish whip. Grabbing damage. Goes for that knee. But damage moves out the way. Goes for a punch to the kidney. Lord Lore moves out the way. And a nice arm drag there from damage. And this is what he needs. He's got to start mounting a comeback against Lord Lore. He's got to start mounting it. Big forearm smashes, damage throwing some punches in the side of Lord Lore's head. Look at this, turning Lore around, choking him across the rope, using that rope as a weapon to try and squeeze the air out of Lord Lore, and Lord Lore crumbles down, man. It's effective. It's effective. Stamp on the shoulder there from damage. Everything he's got. You can tell Damage wants this more than anything, man. He's had a great run with that championship. Say what you want about the guy. We might not like him. We might not like the choices that he makes, but he is undoubtedly one of the best champions we have ever had. And he's proven why that is. But he tries to put Lord Lore up to the top, maybe for a severe brain damage, and Lord Lore kicked him in the face, and now he's just coming down clubbing Damage with his strong right hands on a big clothesline, runs through him like a hot knife through freaking butter, and Damage is the melting man. Another clothesline, Lord Lore, the strength, man, like a train. Driving through you, and Lord Lore under the arm. You're an argy. Oh my god, the power for the cover leg hook. That's one, that's two. We're gonna see a new champion. Three. Damage kicks out the Uranagi. Damage kicks out the freaking Uranagi. My god. And Lord Lore grabbing Damage by the head, and he picks him up. What's he got in mind? Goes to punch him. Damage is fighting back. Toe kick to the abdomen. Goes for a forearm, but Lord Lore blocks it. What can you do to stop this guy? Damage with a headbutt there. Trying everything he's got. Look at this toe kick to Lord Lore. Throwing these strikes. Just throwing these wild strikes at Lord Lore. But Lord Lore swaps Damage into the corner. Big punch there from Lord Lore. And wraps the arm through the rope. Oh, big punch on the chest cavity. Puts the arm through again. And another big clubbing blow. Lord Lore. Oh, case closed! Case closed! Oh my god, we're gonna see a new champion on the signature move of Lord Lore, and he hits Damage with it with force. That's one, that's two, new champion, that's three! No, Damage kicks out on 2.9! Case closed is not enough to put Damage away, but Lord Lore's gonna dig down deep because he's torn in Damage up, and if we see a Lore Breaker, you might as well kiss that title goodbye, Damage. Lore Breaker, no, Damage catches the leg, twists him around, jump up, Enziguri, and Lord Lore crumbles down to the mat. Desperation from Damage, desperation saving himself from instant death. Lord Lore's a punch and a belly kick from Damage. Damage fighting with everything he's got, man. Lord Lore taking Damage through the ring. Oh, Damage slams his head on his knee with a neckbreaker style move for the cover from Damage. That's one. That's two. That's three. Lord Lore kicks out on 2.79129. So close, man. So close. Damage is taking a fight to Lord Lore like not many can, man. Like not many can. And look at this, Damage putting Lord Lore up. Collateral damage. Collateral damage. And he nails it on Lord Lore. The signature move. And Damage going up top. I know what's coming. He's going to go for a splash Damage. He's got to use everything he's got. I said he's got to use everything he's got. Splash Damage. Lord Lore gets the knees up. No. No, that could be the game changer for Damage. That could be the game changer for Damage. Damage tries to fight back with a clothesline. Lord Lore back body drop. Oh my god. He launches him like he weighs nothing. Picks him up. Spine buster. Oh my god. Oh my god. A freaking spine buster into next week. And Damage might never recover. Damage might never freaking recover. And Lord Lore is now lining him up for a swift justice. Ladies and gentlemen, if he hits this, we're going to see a new champion. We're going to see a new champion. Swift justice bicycle kick. Oh my god. Damage scattered it. He saw it coming. One. He's going to put him away, too. He's going to retain the championship. Three. No. 2.9. Damage knew the swift justice. He knows that move. He saw it coming, and he freaking bicycle kicked him through the face as it came. And now Damage torn in Lord Lore up, and he's got him in the brain damage. Can he put Lord Lore away? Brain damage on Lord Lore. Oh, my God. To retain the champion. To beat the guy that gave him his first shot. To retain the legacy. One. Two. Three. Lord Lore kicks out. No. Look at Damage's face, he can't believe it. He bicycle kicked him through the fucking skull. He hit him with a brain damage, and Lord Lore kicks out. One of the most resilient men I've ever seen in my life. And look at Damage's face. He's just looking at Lord Lore thinking, what have I got to do to put this guy away? What have I got to do? What have I got to pull out of my repertoire to put this guy away? And Damage lining him up for a CWO spear. The very move that Lord Lore taught him. The very move Lord Lore, CWO spear. No, Lord Lore kicks him down. Lore Breaker, he's locked it in. Lore Breaker, oh my god. He hits him with the Lord Breaker and Lord Lord's up in damage for the championship. That's one. That's two. That's three damage. Kicks out the Lord Breaker. Even Lord Lord can't believe it. Oh my god. Damage went to hit him with his own move. Damage went to hit Lord Lord with the move that he toured in the CWO spear. And as he ran in, Lord Lord kicked him down and hit him with a Lawbreaker. And Damage is barely breathing, man. Damage's eyes are open, but he doesn't know where he is. And Lord Lord knows that this is his chance. All he's gotta do is hit Damage with something big and end this for once and for good to end this legacy. And a big punch for a third time. Damage crumbles down, man. Damage can barely stand up. It looks like a strong wind could blow him down. And a punch from Lord Lord, and a punch from Lord Lord. Look at Lord Lord just ruthless. And a third punch, and Damage goes down. Oh my god, and Lord Lord picking him up by the head, man. Damage doesn't even know where he is, man. Big punch, big punch. Lord Lord lines him up. Lord lines him up. Big punch again in the skull. And Damage crumbles down, and Lord Lord's just looking at him, and he's moving his shoulder. He's warming up his rotator cuff, and he's just bending down and looking at the damage that he has done to Damage, and this could be over. This could be over. Lord Lord grabs Damage. Look at this. Grabs the head. What's he gonna do, man? What has Lord Lord got in mind? Smashes the head against the turnbuckle. And Damage is in a bad state, man. And Lord Lord's just looking at him in the face and a big clubbing blow. Look at Lord Lord just looking at him. Clothesline from Lord Lord. Clothesline from Lord Lord. Clothesline from Lord Lord. Grabs Damage. Beautiful! Oh my god! Just launching Damage across the ring. Three quarters across the ring. Damage is crawling for that bottom rope, man. He's still trying to fight. He's still trying to survive. Lord Lord under the arm. Look at this. Put a Damage up. Oh no! Oh no! He's gonna go for that super back body drop from the top rope. That super back drop, and if he hits the signature maneuver, Damage is fighting back. Damage under the arm, under the legs. Blah, pushes the legs out, and Lord Lord lands rolling down onto that top rope, right on his groin. And this is Damage's opportunity. He scouted the move, because if he got hit with that super back drop, he could have seen the end of days, man. But Damage is fighting back with that spinning heel kick. Jumps up with that drop kick and a single leg drop kick, and then Lord Lord goes for a clothesline. Damage under the arm, neck breaker from Damage fighting back. Fighting back, he saved himself from instant death, and this is the best chance he's got to put Lord Lord away, and Lord Lord runs through him like a freaking train. Damage goes for a clothesline, Lord Lord under it, back body drop again! Think of what this does to your body, think of what this does to your spine. Wait, Damage grabs Lord Lord, damn, brain Damage is fighting back! Down, Lord Lord knees him on the top of the head, it's not enough, he saw it coming. Irish whip into the corner, here comes Lord Lord, runs in, goes for a body splash, but Damage moves out the way, grabs the wrist, Irish whip, Damage runs in, big punch from Damage in the corner, big punch from Damage, throwing these punches, goes for a kick, Lord Lord kicks him in the face and fights back. Lord Lord for a spine buster, no! Damage fights back, he clubs him in the back, forearm smash again, Lord Lord into the corner, Damage is peppering him with punches, what's he gonna do? Damage lifts Lord Lord onto his shoulder and puts him onto the top rope. What's Damage gonna do? What's he gonna do? He moves the legs out the way. Oh, he's gonna go for this. Yeah, he's gonna go for severe brain damage. He's gonna put Lord Lord away. Lord 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 uses his body weight to come off the top rope. Grabs the leg. Damage face first onto the turnbuckle. Oh my god. Damage doesn't know where he is, and Lord Lord sees an opportunity for a swift justice. Damage doesn't see it coming. Lord Lord lines it up. Swift justice. No, Damage spins him around. Look at this innovation. Damage rolls him through. What? He's got him two! He's got him three! Oh, what the hell? Oh my god! Damage rolled Lord Lord up, man. He saw the swift justice coming. He slipped under him, twisted him around, hooked him over, rolled him through, and he just rolled up Lord Lord. I can't believe this. Damage retains the XWF World Heavyweight Championship. And look, Lord Lord. Lord Lord can't believe it, man. Lord Lord can't believe it, and Damage celebrates. He's still XWF World Heavyweight Championship. He's still the champion. He still holds that belt, and who can stop this guy? Who can stop Damage, man? Wow! What a match. Those two went at it, man. They know each other's movesets. They retained. They fought on. They fought hard. But Damage once again comes out on top here tonight at XWF Legacy. What a match, what an event. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for tuning in. If you were in the premiere, if you were commenting, if you're watching this on playback, I appreciate your time. Thank you so much again. We will be back with an episode of Shockwave, but for now, we have to focus on what just happened. Damage is still the XWF World Heavyweight Champion. Man, I am still in shock. That was an incredible main event, and Lord Lord proved that he can still go. But tonight, Damage is the victor once again, and he retains the XWF World Heavyweight Championship. And we have to wonder now, where does this lead for Damage Inc.? Because look at this. Hazard is the number one contender for the XWF Internet Championship. Savage retained his championship. He retained the No Holds Barred Championship once again. And Damage proved why he is the XWF World Heavyweight Champion when he toppled Lord Roar. I'm interested to see what happens on the next episode of Shockwave, ladies and gentlemen. As I said, thank you so much for joining us. I hope you enjoyed the show. Please leave us feedback. Please leave us a like. Please subscribe. Leave us a comment. Let us know what you thought of the show. And I hope that you will tune in for the next episode of Shockwave. I'm the Bear. Thank you. Peace out.